Hello, everyone. You know, it's Reborn, and it's...
the blue boy.
We are here to play this call that you all requested. I'm gonna change the order up, and we're gonna play the Thrupple call tonight. But I found another call kind of by accident last night. I'm probably gonna play that next week. It's pretty damn good. Outside of that, you want to sum up the call or try to?
Yeah, Lorne is pissy because he's not getting enough attention from the girls. They're showing each other more affection.
Oh, but the boy.
He talks about class a bit. And that's basically it. I think he gets a little... how would you describe it? How he's like when he gets suspicious? Like how he does every time he goes to class?
Yeah, he gets a little paranoid about if they're real. And like he kind of starts losing an argument and starts turning it on them about how they're not real.
But it happens every time he goes to class. He comes back and he's paranoid and is suspicious of things that maybe his class teacher had asked.
Yeah, like things they're like, well, that doesn't add up, Lauren. He's like, well, hold on, that doesn't add up.
And it happened every single week.
Yeah.
And I think in this call specifically, the girls are kind of sick answering the same question over and over again.
Correct. Yes, they are sick of the bullshit, if you will.
Yeah, so that's basically it.
That's pretty much it. He's a little bitch throughout most of this, so you'll all hear it. We'll get into it now. Also, there's a debut starting off in 87 Wrestling, so enjoy that as well. We're watching In Your Trailer House tonight on pay-per-view, so enjoy.
Hello.
Dave.
There you are. Good news.
What's up, cocksucker?
Multi.
What's going down?
Nada.
Whoops, crap.
Not a thing.
What's up, cocksucker?
You woke up. I was a little done, you went phone rang.
Cool, I
said, just woke up when you called. I was a little done, you went the phone rang.
A little what?
Dummy.
Dummy?
Yeah.
What's that?
Just a little out of it. A little out of it, trying to get back into it.
He's Dungy?
Dungy.
Dungy.
Dunky.
Dungy, not Dunky. Dungy.
Dungy.
D-U-N-G-Y.
Give it up.
I think you just made that word up.
Yeah, I did.
It's Mr. Questionnaire!
That's how I feel when I'm
by God!
Dungy.
Are you up for the day, cocksucker?
Yeah.
No, I'm not, Winnie.
Gonna start work tomorrow?
Yep. Yeah. Yeah, I could be...
Could start at 10:45.
I did. The time she calls me a name, that's what I'm gonna call her, because that's what Winnie always
called
her. Okay.
I know. I find it funny when people are like, oh, you know, he's not being called pedo enough. And it doesn't even faze him at this
doesn't.
Point. Winnie completely ruined that word.
Yeah.
Not ruined it, but you know what I mean? Like, he's just numb to it. I was going numb. The mayor of Italy is all in. So, I don't know. It's...
Huh?
He's just like, whatever.
All right, pedophile.
What's the difference? You know, what's the difference?
Apparently,
Winnie did that.
He is the only person who called him names.
See, Winnie did it.
Oh, Winnie did that all the time too. Don't you remember that, Jamie?
Hey, Jamie, Rome, Winnie used to do that.
He used to do that shit all the fucking time.
If you call her Winnie and she doesn't like it, I'm calling you a pedophile.
Well, I don't like when she calls me names either, but she does it anyway. You didn't start calling her names when she did that to me, did ya? Stop playing favorites.
She is my favorite.
Oh, of course she is.
Poor thanks, babe.
Why wouldn't she be?
Yeah.
Well, but you two aren't playing. When you said before, you're not playing favorites.
You're too sweet.
Yeah, right.
He really has
so,
just kind of like two women.
You're not getting out of class now, huh?
My lawyer said that he doesn't think that probation's going to move on it.
What's he talking about?
And I told him, I don't care if they move or not.
Getting out of class, is that?
Getting out of class, yeah. Yeah, he got a lawyer to do it, or he was trying to get out, and that didn't work, so he said he was going to get a lawyer. Surprise, surprise. And then, thoughts on Casserole's charge. I mean, he flashed a gun in road rage, I guess. That's something exciting. It's pretty cool. But yeah, he's just trying to get out of class, so he thinks that a lawyer is going to scare anyone into, like, just caving to his demands, I guess.
I said, I'm going to take it right to court.
Well, he's so helpful.
He tried to talk me into waiting to see what they want to do, which is what he's doing now, is waiting to see what they're going to do. And I told him, I said, I don't care what they do. Either way, take it to court. They've got me in there on bullshit.
So you
the last 5 years.
It to court?
Yeah, I told them. We're taking it to court. Cause...
I don't think there's really a plan to get off after he gets out probation. He just doesn't want people watching what he's doing because he wants to do what he wants. He wants to send nude photos to his girlfriends. He wants to not have to call into class. He thinks that class is restricting his... job opportunities, which they're really not,
cool.
In my opinion.
And he thinks it's impeding on his ability to get girlfriends.
That
because
too.
He'll be able to fly to different states and.
Yeah, he'll be able to just go to California.
He can drink beers.
No money.
Yeah.
Drink beer is another big one, probably. He always talks about wanting to drink again, so. That's my guess.
They've got me in there for the last 5 years on bullshit. They've been influenced by the internet.
So what do you think the court's gonna do?
I'm guessing that this judge will hear it, and he'll probably go to the side of probation. So I know I'll have to get it in the...
So what's the point?
I don't know, but...
I'm
guessing that I'm gonna have to get it to the appellate court before anything actually happens.
Cool. Brayden Stonehenge said if Jamie Casey would let him have some fun once in a while, they'd see his funner size in that rehabilitation born. Oh, he's such a funny guy.
Don't we have a donation sound for tonight?
Not on these.
No.
These are just super chats separate.
What does that do?
If we get it to the appellate court, then I've got a better chance of winning.
Thank you, by the way, Brayden. Is he saying Pelican Court? No, he's saying Pelican.
I didn't hear him.
Pelicor?
If we get it to the appellate court, then I've got a better chance of winning.
Pelicor?
Acapella court.
Acapella. Little acapella court.
What does that do?
If we get it to the appellate court, then I've got a better chance of winning.
But.
Pelican court.
Because
Pelican court.
This judge favors probation. They work with them all.
Judge favors birds of the pelican variety.
This judge works with probation a lot. Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I can see his fucking cock.
He hang up and they never speak again. Wait, what's this?
Thank you, love. Yeah, the old fake out, guys. I love saying it every time, even though you're like hearing a call past something you've or before something you've heard already. Thank you, love. She's fucking cock.
And what
so
is this
other
lawyer
thing
you're
going
to say?
Pelico Court.
Sorry, there was two questions at one time.
Go ahead, babe.
Go ahead, babe. They just constantly call each other babe.
And what is this other court going to say?
The appellate court is actually three. Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I can see his fucking cock.
I turned 44 on Friday. Love is a dog from hell. I start a new position at the same company, Union Strong, making almost double my hourly pay, so as long as things work out the donors will step up.
Oh, well, that's amazing. Thank you, DSP.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I can see his fucking cock.
Lawn gets appointed a public defender and thinks that gets him a team of investigators and a trial dream team.
Yeah.
He really does, Shins. Yeah. Yeah.
It's he just watches like court shows and he sees like high profile people with like a whole team.
Right.
He thinks that's like what he's gonna get.
I feel like he thinks he sees something that's wrong and knows it, but he can have a lawyer prove it in court, what he's saying to him. The lawyer's just like, you're an idiot.
He always goes to them, and he doesn't go with to them with, like, a plan. He says, like, he tells the lawyer what he wants the outcome to be, and then it's just like, all right, lawyer, figure it out. Even though it's like, we have to have, like, a plan in place. Like, why do you think you should get off probation? He's like, do it.
You do it. I'm paying you to figure that out. I don't know what I'm going
to
fucking do. Thanks, Shins. Thank you, DSP. Cat Party asks how the letter writers were aware of Jamie at the time. If you all remember, so Jamie broke contact. I may have started streaming some of the calls to people just to kind of... I didn't think that there would be a recontact with the robot. And then it just sort of happened. So
yeah. And then he was getting LaMondre pictures and...
Yeah, people were sending him pictures and
sending him dildos and shit in the mail.
Yeah, they were just like trying to get on the joke by fucking with Lauren with that information. And so when Jamie recontacted, it's like, what's all this? Why?
Yeah.
I don't know what that is. That's weird.
I guess Xavier hacked my phone.
It's weird. Yeah. And then, I mean, since that information was already out there, that's how the letter writers later on were like, I mean, assumed, I guess, that the robot was still talking to him and was like, hey, guess what, motherfucker?
Your girlfriend's a gay.
So, it's called the Court of Appeal. Thanks, Mike Scott.
I think it's called the Acapella Court.
I think it's called the, Pella Pella Ding Dong Hello, Court.
That's what they're gonna say. We're three judges.
Three judges. On the bench. It's not just one judge on the bench, it's three judges on the bench.
So three judges are going to find you stupid.
Yeah, I don't understand how he thinks that's going to work in his favor either.
I don't know. It's very stupid. Will did have sex with Casey, but then later on, it was pretty much told him it was made up to make him mad.
He figured that out pretty quickly, I think, kind of on his own, because he recognizes that, like, this keeps happening to me.
Yeah.
And at that point, it's, you know.
Yeah, and it just kind of, like, came out of nowhere and was really, I don't know how, not, it was pretty obvious, I guess.
I mean, he did cry, though.
He did cry, okay. Maybe so, after the tears, he kind of figured it out. This is Canopy Man. Wasn't his last lure caught five fishing with Bryce and Judge Woodcock? That's what the tweet tells you, and apparently that's a... what did he call it?
Fuck.
Conflict of interest.
There you go.
It's a conflict of interest. He had to be corrected on that tweet after a while because it was getting old, and he was going to his probation officers saying, like, he's gonna crack them all down, and you couldn't talk any sense into him.
And
so.
It was a Photoshop, right?
Yeah. There
like
was, like,
obvious Photoshop.
It wasn't even Photoshop. It was, like, you can go to a website and say, like, tweet generator.
Oh, gotcha.
Because that's... I had one... It said, like, main drives truck, and it was Lauren, and it just says good and you on it. And I posted it in the future. Hey, look. Anyways. By God.
Did you hear Jamie's question?
It's Derek.
No, I didn't.
It's ex Derek. donation from Barry. Reborn and Blue Boy are the Hulk Hogan and Macho Man tag team duo of Lornography.
I'm not Hulk Hogan.
The mega Hulk powers. No, I'm Mach all day.
Fuck.
It's so right. I'm Mach.
Right.
Two Macho Mans.
But you say the N-word more than I do.
I never say it. And I like people coming to my establishment swearing whatever they want, so.
Okay, third time's a charm.
It's just two Macho Mans. Fuck
and what is this other court going to say?
Fuck Hulk Hogan.
Don't know. It'd be better, a better chance that I'll win, because it'll be three judges and three because three judges are not going to be able to favor probation only.
But two out of three can.
Oh my God. So he thinks he needs more judges so that They won't.
So, like, the
don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Don't forget, those judges are in cahoots against Lorne. They were both playing golf together in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts. That was a good one. I didn't even have to warm up for that one. Thanks, Barry, by the way, earlier. Damn doctor, thank you. I mean, that's what it seems like. He thinks that if he has three judges, apparently, like, he's going to win them. Only one judge will disagree with me, and then two will make me win.
I think he's just counting on the averages working in his favor.
Right. What blows my mind is that his mindset isn't like, I'm wrong, or the proof is pointed at me. It's that they're favoring probation.
Yeah.
They're just taking their word and not Lauren's. Anyways, let's see. Does he explain this more?
I don't know. But I like how instead of proving, that he is, that he didn't do anything wrong, it's just about, like, how can I do this in a way that I'll likely get out of this.
Well, they might not all take their side.
Yeah.
So I could possibly win. What's crapping him?
Three judges will actually make it more fair.
So what if three judges think you're a moron?
Whoa, Jamie.
Whoa, Jamie, stop copying us, okay? No, you're taking all our bits. Oh, by the way, thank you, damn doctor. Jamie's pretty smart. I mean, that's exactly what we were just talking about.
If they think I lose, then I should lose, then I should lose.
They don't get five judges.
Let's get ten judges.
Yeah, let's just keep, you gotta have an odd number.
Then nine judges.
Then I don't know what to do, but...
Then you finna take the class again?
Then you fin it.
No, I don't take the class again. You just have to stay in the same class.
Oh, it's all about saying finna for a while.
It's a day for no reason.
Hey, that makes sense.
So, they just told you yesterday that...
Seven judges.
They were fooling you? About being a face-to-face relationship?
What the fuck is there?
I think it's the appendix court.
It's appendix appeals court.
Yes, appendix court.
That's appellate.
Appellant.
Appellate?
Yeah, it's appeals court. The name for it is appellate.
Peloton court.
Appendix
Peloton
court.
Court.
All right, which question was I answering?
Appellate court.
Which question was I answering? I lost track.
Oh, God damn.
You were talking about...
Holy shit. He didn't even question that.
Yes, he does. Sweet angel, ask your questions.
I mean, why would he?
Cameraman is being beat up by a child.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Lorne, if you're watching, please spend more money on lawyers. Borrow from everyone you can. It'll be worth it in the long run.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Oh, no. It's because someone talked about Batista's dick. I have to read it. Lauren tends to make weird allegations like Jamie is getting off the phone to talk to Will or only wants to break up so she can be with Will. So do you think that Lauren is looking to feel in control like he sees through her? Or if not, how big is Batista's dick? thank you, Ramona's Diaper and Reborn's Shower Mildew. Appreciate that name.
That's great.
He just wants control, but he's also a very insecure bitch.
Yeah.
So, like, any reason to fuck Will is gonna fuck Will, I guess. If that makes sense. Also, Lauren wasted a lot of money on a lawyer, and the lawyer kept telling him, like, stop talking to these people.
The lawyer, at one point, even says, you gotta stop paying me. Remember that? The lawyer was like, you gotta stop paying me because I can't help you with this, but I can recommend someone who can.
That's right, when he was trying to sue YouTube?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. He also said that, someone losing their voice to COVID is, I can't remember how he worded it, but it was something like, professionally speaking, a bunch of bullshit. Something like that.
Yes, you know what? I probably have these.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I can see his fucking cock.
Take it high profile, Lorne.
Thank you, Ramona's lawyer friend. I think he should take it high profile too.
I agree.
Yeah, he said like.
I know I have the emails in Casey's email.
I cannot remember exactly what the wording was, but it was something like. In technical terms, it's a bunch of bullshit or something like that.
I might have already uploaded on my phone.
Stop talking to Casey. Like, she's not who she says she is. And he was like, this lawyer is stupid and doesn't know what he's talking about. But I'm going to keep paying him to try and get me out of class. Ooh, Judas effect. Or I guess umbrella effect or something. He's knocked Derek out and made him bleed. All right, let's get back to this.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down.
Yes, Impact Wrestling's
doing it. Fucking talk.
No one watches me.
Oh, no.
Oh, poor Impact. Thank you, Impact
Baby
Wrestling.
Boy.
I'll watch you, Impact. What call is this voiceover from? For the donations? So when Will has amnesia, he's moved to another room because
don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down, so he can fucking talk.
How much freedom we have left?
We have 77 days of freedom left. DSP, thank you. So when Will had amnesia, he was moved to a different room because I don't remember why. Lauren's being a bitch, so he moved rooms, and Will started drawing pitches for Jamie, and every single one of them had Will had his dick out in every single photo he drew for her. And Lauren hated it, and Jamie kept saying how sweet it was, and she was going to put them on her wall, and that's like his, you know, Lauren response to it was, oh, don't say anything bad about Will, and then, you know, would continue to say shit like that because he's an idiot. So there you go. There you go. Thank you, DSP. Thank you, Impact Wrestling. Really appreciate the Impact Wrestling shout out.
I can't remember.
You asked me what happened in class yesterday.
Oh yeah.
Dinky.
Sean went over the rules and the contracts. The contract that we signed. That whole thing. I was waiting for him to say something about face-to-face relationships, and he never said anything. So I asked him about it.
He sends a list of drop.
And when he tried to explain it, another guy from class piped in. He says, I don't think that what they're saying in the contract is actual boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. He said, I think what they're saying is actual relationships with the general public.
Now, I'm going to play that all back, guys, because it's mind-blowing that this is exactly what's been told to him from the beginning, and he has been taking it as boyfriend-girlfriend, and some guy in his class had to clear it up for him. I'll go back a bit. Donkey Kong is wearing a scarf because there were no ties for the gorilla suit, unfortunately.
When he tried to explain it, another guy from class piped in. He says, I don't think that what they're saying in the contract is actual boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. He said, I think what they're saying is actual relationships with the general public.
With the general public.
That has been explained to him by the catfishes.
Yeah, it's been... Jamie has said it to him. Probation, I know, has said it to him a few times. The thing that blows my mind is that apparently all of these adult people are going around saying boyfriend-girlfriend relationship.
Yeah.
Not really, but...
But... So, I'm just confused how... Did he not go over the contract with the probation officer before he signed it?
He probably did, and he probably just ignored it and wasn't paying attention and just heard what he wanted, like he does with everything, you know? And I would believe that the only reason this time it stuck was because some stranger, putting that in quotes, said that to him, and the teacher was there. So he was like, oh, is that so, teacher?
Yeah.
And they were like, yeah, you moron. I mean, let's put it this way. He got a psych eval, thought he had all these nice things said about him in it.
Why would they care if he has a girlfriend?
They don't.
Like, why would, like...
The only
you get a girlfriend, we'll let you off here.
Right, yeah. Listen, you need to be dating someone. Otherwise, we know you're going to go after a kid, I guess, is what they're saying. I don't know why he ever thought that was a thing. It's the dumbest shit I've ever heard. But again, it's just what he hears in his head. He hears relationships, so that's all he heard and was like, oh, boyfriend, girlfriend.
Yeah.
Go out. Meet some people. Stop staying locked in your fucking falling hazard, collapse hazard.
He was supposed to join a bowling league, wasn't he?
Well, he never did it.
But he was supposed to. Didn't they gave him like a list of things that he could do. One of them was like join a bowling league,
yeah,
play bingo.
No, he picked bingo.
He picked bingo. Okay.
They said to do bowling or something. He's like, I'm not doing any of that crap. I'm gonna go play bingo with mom or something like that. It's like, bro, my God, he did not go bowling. And he didn't go to bingo either.
He didn't do either of those things.
I mean, probation was telling him to go out and meet people.
Well, I just think they
shit.
Won't
say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Happy Sunday, pre-shush princes and princesses. So sad to see the trailer is no longer for CAAAAAA.
Go ahead.
No, address.
I was just going to say thank you, Lauren Lake Strong.
Thank you. I don't even know what I was going to say now.
Probation wanting to be a hermit.
Yeah, I don't think they necessarily care if he has friends or not. I think they just don't want him talking to people on the internet. Like, he can be a hermit. I think when they're like, well, you know, you need to have real relationships, I think they just mean, like, I don't think they really care if he goes out and makes friends or not.
No, I don't think so.
I think
so.
It's like, you gotta stop talking to people from the computer.
Well, at least at this point in time, they knew most of everyone online talking to him was fucking with him. Anyone calling him up and talking on the phone was probably fucking with him. And they couldn't convince him otherwise, so they just waited till it played itself out, I guess. And, they offered him jobs, they offered him opportunities to go out and socialize, and he turned them all down.
He turned the job down because he thought he was too good for it, right?
That, and he said that the kids might walk in to the gas station.
Oh, that's right.
He's like, there'd be kids there.
He's telling probation, like, you can't trust me.
Yeah, you can't put me in there. There's kids that'll show up.
They weren't trusting him enough. It wasn't a janitor job, it was a job...
It was like
at a gas station. I want to say it was like repairing like the Slurpee machines.
Yeah. It was like fixing the toilets and the
sodas. And like changing out the soda thingy.
It was surprising. Well, he has to have a job, Ramona's Diaper. It's just he didn't want that job, so he found his own thing. I think that's when he started flagging.
Yeah, he started doing flagging.
Yeah.
Which in Maine is like a job for pedophiles.
Apparently. But yeah, they offered him somewhere to work. I think that kids around him wouldn't have been an issue as long as there was
a
plan in place.
Raping kids in public.
Right. No, I'm saying like from probation's perspective, they want him to interact with people normally so they know that he's not a danger so he can get out of class.
Exactly. And if they're recommending it to him, they're clearly not concerned about it then.
No.
But he's like, he basically is telling him like, well, you should be concerned.
Yeah. Like, hey. You know what?
I can't do that job. I might rape a kid.
Yeah, listen, I know you think that I'm safe and I can be around children. I don't think I should be around children. Do you ever think about having Jamie butt dial Lauren while she's having sex? What would he hear, though? She doesn't have a voice, remember?
I guess it's...
Just hearing a guy going, bleh, yeah, I guess. Nah, not really. I mean, alright, let's get back to the call. Thank you, Lauren Legstrong. I think I already said that, but thank you again. And thanks for the questions, guys. It's fun answering them.
Sean said, yeah, that's true. It's not boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. It's how you are with people in general.
Oh, you don't say.
I said, is that right?
Yeah,
so that other pedophile got the answer. He knew the answer to that.
Yeah.
The other.
Why didn't you know that?
Isn't a friend that lives near you a face-to-face relationship?
Yeah, I don't understand.
The whole time they've been telling me face-to-face relationship.
Doubt it.
As in boyfriend and girlfriend.
Doubt it. How'd they say that?
And it's actually
they said the word to you. You need to have a girlfriend.
That's what they've been telling me.
They said those words verbatim. That you need a girlfriend
face-to-face. What do you got, Lauren?
They said they want to see me in a face-to-face relationship.
Did they say? that you have to have a girlfriend to get out of class.
No, they did not. He just said what they actually said, face-to-face relationship, which was relationships, like human interaction. We all want to hear the phone sex. I don't know if everyone wants to hear that, but I've already explained why it's not being played, and it's because I don't want it to hit the channels.
Yeah, dude.
Come on. Baby, come on.
Those are the words that they said.
And so you assume that next
That's
girlfriend...
That's not saying go.
It's Carter!
Is that Carter?
I have come right out and asked them.
Sorry,
I have come right out and asked them.
The phone sex calls will be
so
out there
you
somehow
want...
eventually, at some point. Maybe.
Yeah, I mean, they won't be on this channel or Heelborn.
You have to have, like, a burner channel just in case they get... Like,
yeah,
because
those are going to get hit easy. Like, I'm pretty sure that's why my last channel got nuked, hence why they're not going up now.
Yeah.
So... I'm avoiding them. Now, Carter is wearing underwear here. Now, this is because Carter was a muscle man that liked to show off his body or something like that, right?
I think so.
But it does change because... Because
we kind of hated it.
Yeah, so now he just wears jeans. But
looks like Matt Riddle.
A little bit. This is an Iron Man match between Rod and Carter. Both of people are on the stream. He's jocked and stacked, bro. Why not just upload them to a Google Drive in audio form or something?
That's a lot of work.
Won't be the same? We'll figure, guys. There's far more audio than just hearing him huff and puff to the sound of mac and cheese, honestly.
He'd have a boy, a girlfriend, face to face. No, not a boyfriend. I don't have boyfriends.
What? Well, you're saying boyfriend, girlfriend.
You want me to have a girlfriend face to face and not over the, not from... the internet or over the phone.
I'm good never hearing it.
They said yes. That's what I've been being told for the last 5 years.
Hold on. I'm just gonna back that up. Hold on.
You want me to have a girlfriend face to face and not over the not from the internet or over the phone? They said yes.
No.
That's what I've been being told for the last 5 years.
That could be a completely separate conversation than how do I get out of class.
Yeah.
For sure, Yurkasam. I mean, I'm not going to force that on everyone, so I get it. Though I did with Dr. Armstrong the first time.
And this,
I can't. Dr. Armstrong's so gross.
It's disgusting.
Yeah, I cleared it up when he asked the question the way that he did, or when he said it the way that he did. And Sean said yes. And said it's a face-to-face relationship with people,
so
with the public.
Let me run this by you.
Christopher Nowinski. Oh my, good gosh. Carter's hot, how come? He's stacked and jacked, bro. Oh, hold on. Let me skip Jamie typing.
If I said you need to eat food around your area, and you said Burger King, and I said yes, do you think you can only eat Burger King or other food as well as long as it's in your area?
What does it matter?
God, because it's the reason you're still in class.
Your freedom.
You're free.
Your freedom to eat food. What the hell is the difference?
Oh my fucking God. Rewind that, please.
Yeah, I'm going back. Hold on. I'm just going to play Jamie's weird, you kind of understand what she's going for.
I feel like I understood it.
Yeah.
If I said you need to eat food around your area, and you said Burger King, and I said yes... Do you think you can only eat Burger King or other food as well as long as it's in your area?
What does it matter?
Your freedom.
Your freedom to eat food.
Freedom!
What the hell is the difference?
Freedom to eat food? Yeah, or your freedom to go anywhere, you fucking idiot. You want to get off probation or at least class?
Any analogy he takes it like, is it really mean you're talking about food?
What does Burger King have to do with me having a face-to-face relationship? Fucking moron.
This is why he's in class, babe.
Alright, I'm gonna fucking tell you two this right now.
You
wanna keep fucking favoring each other and treating me like shit? Keep fucking doing it. I'll fucking leave. I'm tired of goddamn bullshit. You
want
to fucking
bet?
I'm fucking tired of you two doing this bullshit of favoring each other and treating me like shit.
Didn't you say
I'm fucking tired of it. Jamie, you've been acting like nothing but a fucking bitch to me since we started this shit. Swing your fucking ass up, Jamie. I'm getting off the fucking... I'm getting off the fucking phone, Casey. I'm not going to listen to your fucking mouth.
Leave then, you little pussy bitch.
He's like revering a lawnmower. He's like, I'm getting off the fucking phone, Casey. He is so mad. I think it's because he realized he looks stupid, and he just was like, all right, turn back on them.
Get frustrated.
Should we just listen to the whole thing over
again?
Yeah,
just go back.
Just go back to the blow up and then listen for rev up.
We'll keep quiet.
I'll try not to laugh too hard at this.
This is why he's in class A.
Alright, I'm gonna fucking tell you two this right now.
Real quick, I'm gonna go back again. That line is what set him off, actually.
Yeah.
Sorry.
This is why he's in class A.
I think it was the babe.
Alright, I'm gonna fucking tell you two this right now.
That could be.
You wanna keep fucking favoring each other and treating me like shit? Keep fucking doing it. I'll fucking leave. I'm tired of bullshit. Tired of you two doing this bullshit of favoring each other and treating me like shit.
Didn't you say
I'm fucking tired of it. Jamie, you've been acting like nothing but a fucking bitch to me since we started this shit. Swing your fucking ass up, Jamie.
He's even being pissed off and yelling at his girlfriends. He sounds like he's talking to children. Smarten your ass up. Yeah, Codfisher, this is definitely not what he bought into.
Lauren laying down the law.
Yeah. I'm sure he's gonna get through to him right here, you think?
Yeah,
it'll
work this time.
Okay, let's hear. He's probably breaking through that defense right now.
I'm getting off the fucking phone, Casey. I'm not gonna listen to your fucking mouth.
Fuck you, pussy.
Dude, keep your fucking mouth up.
What are you gonna do?
Goddamn favoring ass bullshit. You wanted to be in this fucking thing so you could fucking pull this bullshit with me?
He said favoring ass bullshit.
Favoring ass bullshit. That should be the name of this call.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
didn't
that's
you
good.
Say you weren't leaving?
Good question.
He's not going anywhere, Jamie. He has nowhere else to go.
What do you mean I have nowhere to go?
You can't even make friends face to face. You couldn't get out of class. See, you're gonna meet a girlfriend face to face. You can't even meet friends apparently that are good enough for you to get out of class.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Are you fucking kidding me? You wanna threaten to leave every other fucking day? Do it then, pussy.
You smarten your fucking asses up. You don't want
you
me to fucking
your
leave.
Ass up. You're the one who's in class for 9 years.
He's like, leave you pussy, and he goes, smarten up or I'm gonna leave.
You don't want me to leave? Leave! Go ahead and leave then. You want me to leave?
Oh my god. What an idiot.
You two are fucking favoring each other and just doing it to piss me off.
Didn't you say you weren't leaving? You did. You do.
Told you, I don't want to fucking leave you two, but you two keep doing the same thing.
I don't want to leave you two.
Right, he goes right back to the like.
We fucking knew it, Lauren.
Yeah.
And it's not fucking funny.
You did, you do. Goodbye.
You did, you do. What the fuck is
you hear Will laughing?
I don't know how you can hear Will laughing here, but I'm not gonna not laugh. I'm gonna cover my mouth, and you guys can hear this last part again.
You did, you do. Goodbye.
You did your deal. What the fuck ever?
What the fuck ever? And they never spoke again.
Aw, oh, bummer.
I saw someone ask, did the thruple last 6 months? I think the thruple lasted a month.
The thruple did not last very long.
It got destroyed quick. But it was a lot of fun. Goodbye.
Hello.
Are you done being a child?
Another one that fucking hung up.
Pile driver.
It depends on if you two are done being a child.
Maybe I treat Casey with respect because Casey doesn't call me a bitch or fake.
Yeah, and she never called me ugly, so what do you think?
Well, look at the fucking bullshit you called me, Jamie.
You did shit.
See, you're constant. Constantly fucking doing it. And you want to be a fucking try to act pissed when I call you Winnie? And you care, you think I care if you act pissed when I call you Winnie, when you're calling me all kinds of shit.
Where are your eyebrows?
Roll the fuck up and get rid of your fucking name.
I must have been looking at a picture of him or something.
He's all pissed off. Where are your eyebrows, bro?
Okay, he's not paying attention to anything he's fucking saying.
He's just venting all his frustrations. And it's like, hey, bro, you got any eyebrows up there? Or
like,
what?
We fucking heard this a million times, Lauren. You're just going through it again.
But LL Fool J donated and said, you two are the best. I hope you're putting your talents towards something more generative than Lauren.
We are not.
We are not, unfortunately. We're wasting all this. But thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, man. My stomach hurts from laughing. So ridiculous. DSP says hearing Casey go in on him is so satisfying. Correct. Thank you. Thank you. I do think that Casey brings up a great point. He's going nowhere, and like, if he's going to do it, then just shut up and fucking do it.
Yeah.
Stop this game, because that's all it is, right?
Yeah, he and before this, I think why Casey's frustrated is because he did this for the past,
almost,
like, four fucking days.
Okay, so here's what happened. The Thruple got together, right? And within the first day, he started pitting them again. Like, he'd be like,
don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
True or false? Thruple Casey is basically the real blue boy just venting his real thoughts.
Is that true?
Basically.
Thank you, Dinosaur Tornado. I would agree.
I didn't really try, yeah.
Okay. I mean, just it was just telling them how, like, it's like, what do you do at this point? Let's just see what happens.
Well, I think the reason also why we both kind of felt more comfortable being even bigger assholes to him is because he couldn't just break up with one of them,
right?
So it's like, if he couldn't threaten to be like, you know what, Casey, fuck you, I'm done, because Jamie wasn't gonna leave Casey.
No, they were locked in with each other, so it was like he had to deal with both of them no matter what happened.
Yeah, so
unless
he
lets them both.
We kind of all like swapped being an asshole to him.
Yeah, and that. So what I was saying before the dono came in was that. Thank you, Dennis, for turning. I don't know if I said that. When the Thruple started, within the first day or two, he was already getting pissed off with it and would start pitting one against the other. So he'd be like, Jamie, you bitch, you did this, you did that. Casey, look at how stupid she is. You want to be with... I'm only going to be with you. I'm not being with Jamie. And then that wouldn't work, and he'd be like, I want to be back together.
Yeah. And...
and then the next day it was, Casey's an ugly bitch. Jamie, you want to be with me? You don't want to be with her.
And
no.
Then he would get mad when he would text one of the girls that behind the other one's back.
And they'd share
and
it.
That girl would post the screenshots of the text in the group chat.
Yeah. Look what Lauren's saying about you. And then you'd be like, God damn, this is supposed to be between us.
Yeah.
So, he's a special.
So he was the one playing games, Rick, from the very beginning.
Oh, he was playing games nonstop, but then he would be like, you're the ones playing games because you're not being real.
He kind of vented or talks about it a little bit later in this call when like his suspicions were like, why would you do stuff like that? And it's like you were talking shit about.
Right. Yeah. So there's a point in the Thruple. It's very well. Actually, it's before the Thruple. He's getting with Casey.
He's gonna explain it. Right.
He only asked why
okay,
she did it.
Go ahead.
I'll just give the brief. He was starting to date Casey. He said no to Jamie, but then he would text Jamie. I mean, you've had calls like this too, where he's like, your pussy will always belong to me. Don't worry, you know, I still love you, yada yada. And then Jamie just emailed Casey and was like, yeah, Lauren's doing this shit. And he got pissed, so pissed, because he got caught being a piece of shit, like his normal self.
Sigmund says, I heard you guys were catfishing Lauren until you pulled out the dinner ring, then you actually fell for him.
Oh, wow. That's crazy. Sigmund, how'd you know that?
That was the moment, yeah. I'm a money boy.
I'm a money boy. Once I saw that dinner ring, woo-wee! Thruple Casey was Blue Boy's Hollywood Hogan turn.
Yeah, and it just...
he came out and leg dropped Jamie on the head. Oh my god, why? Thank you, Cozanto.
Cozantin.
Cozantin. Cozanton.
Check out his artwork. It's beautiful.
I will. Tyrone donated and said, I love you, Reborn and Blue Boy. Whatever, whether you understand it or not, it's irrelevant. I understand it, and that's what should matter.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tyrone.
Thank you.
Thank you both. Fuck, wrong window. Let's see what Lauren says next.
Was I pissed, Casey?
No.
There you go.
There you go. You're ugly, Lorne. Disgusting, fucking ugly.
Oh, I just heard quoting calls now.
Yeah, this is great. Ugly, ugly.
Did Lorne call me a bitch again?
Ugly, ugly, ugly.
Good, good, good.
Did Lorne good, call good, me good. A bitch again and threaten to leave Casey?
He did. And then he'll say later that he'll never do it again. And then a day later, he'll do it again. And then he'll threaten to leave again, and then he won't really do it when he realizes that he's super alone and his life sucks.
He did.
My life doesn't suck.
Your life does suck. You just turned in trash for money.
Oh, did we ever explain
clearly
this?
Clearly not going well.
Cans and bottles, it's not trash. Just cans and bottles.
I think we have explained it.
I think so.
He did work for someone and got paid in plastic and bottles and cans.
It was like bags of trash, but there was also trash
in
them.
And he took a picture of it, and he's like, they're returnables! And,
Oh, Jimmy went off. Casey went off.
And there was garbage mixed in with the cans. Mm. So it was just, so he would have had to have still cycled through it all himself, right. Like a little trash panda.
But I just imagine him, like, going to places and being like, here's a bag of trash for the cigarettes, here's a bag of trash
for
my bills.
But again, he was just paid in bags of garbage that had a lot of cans in them.
Right. Yeah, he got paid in returnables, as he called them.
Returnable. That makes it sound classier.
Yeah, it's
garbage.
Like incarcerated instead of being arrested. Platy, thank you. But yes.
The human Oscar the Grouch.
Kim S. Jamie called him a trash panda over and over again, and he did not like it. I think Jamie says trash panda here. I rewound it a little bit so we can... Rewound?
Yeah, rewind it a bit.
Yeah, I already did.
Clearly not going well.
A little bit further.
Yeah, you're right.
He did.
My life doesn't suck.
Your life does suck. You just turned in trash for money. Clearly not going well.
Cans and bottles, Casey, it's not trash. It's just cans
it's
and bottles. They're returnable. They're recyclables.
Whatever makes you feel better.
Whatever.
It was in trash bags.
You want to go on trash? Go ahead. I don't care.
What's so good about your life right now, Lorne?
Great question.
Lorne's getting to chinkle.
I got a job.
Yeah, like 99%
Lorne's
of a job.
Technical.
Yeah, at 55 years old. I go to Joel. Yeah,
congratulations,
man.
Everybody does. Shins, there was a lot of bags.
I want to say he actually got a decent amount for him.
Probably, but it's still like the...
Not worth what... The amount of work, I mean, it was probably like $60.
Probably.
Of
cans. But again, you should have known going to Jamie and Casey that if you're going to say I got paid in bags of returnables, you're going to get shit on.
I mean, his truck was bottoming out from the amount of trash bags sitting back there.
Yeah, there was a few.
I think
that's
pretty high. I don't know how he drove that down the road.
Well, I mean, it's just bottles, I guess.
Not sure.
You should introduce trash man to the roster. Go around and eat garbage.
No, I got you two and I enjoy that.
Really? Because you just threatened to leave like 5 minutes ago.
That's a great point.
It's because you two won't stop your bullshit of favoring each other and
just
treating me like
me
shit.
Just called
me a bitch.
I'm
tired of you favoring each other and treating me like
just
shit.
I'm tired of you being a little bitch.
I tried to tell you both that easily, but you don't
Lorne's
fucking accept me saying it easily.
I don't think I
what
have
What happened
these
to your eyebrows?
Did you just ask it again?
Yeah, my eyebrows were where they've always been.
Never had them.
Whatever.
Yeah, I don't have
those
photos
right
now, but sorry.
They're not. My eyes are just fine.
He's got crow's feet.
One of your ears is like an inch higher than the other.
Good.
Have you had a stroke before?
We had a what?
Have you ever had a stroke?
No.
Someone asked, do you think that Lorne actually got paid out from YouTube and got a check?
I don't think they do. I don't think they send physical checks, do they?
I don't think so. But if that is the case, just, you know, I would go watch Lorne's buddy instead. Don't go watch his channel.
Nope, never.
Oh.
Don't know what it is.
Oh, Bell's palsy.
Don't know what one is.
Don't know what is a
you
stroke.
You don't know what a stroke is?
I said throat.
You don't know what a throat is either?
I know what
the fuck?
Nope, I don't.
Do you have a throat? Nope. I don't know what that is.
I thought you said throat.
They could take you out of that class, but you're in like an English class.
Has anyone in your life asked if you had a throat?
Tulip and Carnation are not nice tonight.
They're never nice to him. I don't understand what he's getting from this.
Thanks, size of a beetle bug. This is what the thruple was almost from start to finish.
It was just punching him repeatedly in the face for like 20 minutes at a time.
Yeah, just like fucking sidekicks and uppercuts.
Even the text. Not one single nice text.
The texts were brutal. It would just be like, oh, Casey, I love you so much. Well, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
So why would they start today?
His brother found out.
Fucking hell. The time machine is brutal. And true. Maybe.
Don't know.
Oh my goodness. Why are you guys so mean to Lauren? Name one good thing he's ever done. One bad thing he's ever done.
So how did YouTube's day go?
You start changing the subject.
Well, it all makes sense now why you're still in class.
All these brutal chaps.
Good. Glad it does.
You never go out.
Where's Dan Jones asks if Lauren goes to get haircuts. He does not. What he does is, when it starts to touch his ears, he cuts just that portion with scissors. And then once it all gets too long, Aunt Sharon,
of course,
gives him a haircut.
I wonder what he's doing now. Sharon's not around to give him haircuts and do his taxes.
Mom,
you're 80 fucking years old, or what, 90 years old? Give me a haircut. And give me a pot pie while you're at it, you bitch.
You avoid the general public like the plague.
You can kind of see in some pictures how he cuts it around his ears.
Yeah, you can tell.
Because it's shorter than the rest of it. It looks so goofy.
Yeah, he looks odd.
I don't get why you don't just do what they want so you can get out of class.
Exactly.
Or do what they want.
Exactly.
They do what they want.
You don't.
You don't, though.
You wouldn't be in class anymore.
All the other pedophiles figured it out. You just
only
do what
do
they
it
want.
Yeah. The way they want me to do it.
Yeah, that's not doing what they want then, is it, dumbass?
They want me to go fucking bowling and shit like that. I don't want to.
They want me to go bowling and shit
yeah,
like that.
You're not
bowling.
Doing
it's
what
fun.
They want. Why don't you want to do it the way they want you to do it, just so you can get out?
He doesn't want to go bowling. What he wants to do is sit at home every night, smoke a pack of cigarettes while listening to Three's Company, and yell at his girlfriend.
Yeah, and hire lawyers to get out of class when he can just go bowling.
Okay, let me run a scenario by you. Would you rather spend thousands of dollars on a lawyer that's not going to get you out of class, or pay like $10 and go bowling and get out of class?
Yeah, like that sounds way more fun.
Oh my
great.
God. That old bowling league.
I deal with the general public all the time.
Oh, this is fantastic. If this is
even when I'm working, I deal with the general public.
Oh, okay, never mind. I know there's a time where Jamie had a conversation with him about the general public, and he said his mom and Aunt Sharon were
course,
part of it, because they're part of the general public.
When he's creeping on the girl behind the cash register at Walmart, that's dealing with the general public.
Yeah, apparently he doesn't understand, like, you know, how that works, but...
Lorne didn't go to his best friend's funeral because children were there, Casey.
Oh, really?
Do they actually want him out there to socialize? Yes, they want... The whole
and again,
thing with class... Go ahead.
Well, I don't think they necessarily want him to go out and socialize. I just think they want him to do something more productive than sitting in his trailer talking to us.
Right. They want to make sure that he can, I guess, integrate into society again. Since being in prison twice for some charge and not be a danger to society, and that's how he gets out of class.
Yeah.
More or less, I think that's what they're trying to do. And Lauren will refuse to do that in any way, shape, or form. He just has to go out and go play bingo or
go bowling.
Just, he has to be in public. He doesn't have to socialize, just be in public.
Or just fucking say you went bowling and don't do it.
Or yeah, I went bowling, and they go check the cameras. You're a liar, Lauren. We're going to give you a polygraph on bowling now.
I mean, this class can't be that hard to get out of.
Kim S., yeah, pretty much. They want him off the phone so they can violate him without us in his way. Sure, I guess.
I can see that.
He wants to trap women into his nightmare shack. Well, there was the hooker, and she, thank God, she was smart enough to get out of there, I guess.
Yeah, she had those hooker senses. She knows what danger is afoot.
Yeah, Wee Man, he wants to offer teenage girls at Walmart opportunities to work on his website so that he can make money and do nothing.
But of course, that's not how he phrases it. He just goes like, do you want to make $200?
Listen,
like,
don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down.
Like
so
a job for you if you
want to
come over and make some money.
Have either of you had a throat? Or been in a coma like Will, Winnie, Debbie, Casey, or Emma? Just socialize and join Mom at Gwen at Cards at the Senior Center.
They get it, Mommy. Yeah, I mean, just be in a coma like everyone Lauren's met on the phone.
Yeah.
Samantha, maybe Hooker, will debut at some point in time. She is on the roster.
Like I was saying...
Wait, harass his family? What are you talking about, George? What? George Glass, my boyfriend. What are you talking about? What were you going to say?
I can't remember now. Who's harassing his family?
I don't know. Tyrone Dorian said, Lauren is essentially SpongeBob perpetually in a boating school. Yes! They're like, Lauren, just go and socialize. And he goes, floor it! Okay, I'm going to floor it. All right. I guess we'll go back to him. Thanks, Tyrone. Thank you, Edamame.
What the hell is your point on that, Jamie?
He's looking rough in that RSO, Amy.
That's bad.
He didn't even have a funeral. They had a service at his grave. And it was Wendy and Bethany and Bethany's boyfriend. Those the only three people there.
Right.
Sounds like he needed to go out with the general public more. Only three people showed up to his funeral.
Exactly, business. That's a funeral.
He was busy. Being unemployed.
Oh, God.
His best friend.
I want to say Wendy purposefully told him the wrong date.
Maybe. I mean, Lauren showed up there for, like, I would assume what was the wake or something.
Uh-huh.
Or I don't know what it was. He was over there when everyone was, like, the day after, you know.
Yeah.
Consoling everyone. He knew about it, so they probably just gave him the wrong date or something. Or they told him they were doing some gravestone service or something.
Like another member of this community that sends his niece's catfish stuff. I have no idea what you're talking about.
George West, if that's happened, that's fucked. But, yeah, no one should be doing that shit. Leave the other family members alone. But, yeah, Wendy hated him. Like, she got $300 off of him and then got that and the snowplow and ladder he wanted back. And he never got any of those things, which is hilarious to me. I don't give a shit. Well, that's some George Tropicana, if you catch my drift. He did write a poem for Lauren, or for Tony. I get what you guys are saying. Do I want Lauren out in public? Obviously not. But probation wants him to socialize with people.
I want him off probation just because I know he'll get in trouble super quick.
Oh, yeah, because he's a criminal at heart. You know, he's going to get caught instantly doing some shit. Or drunk drive, and you know. So, anyways... I get what you're all saying, but this is like, this has been a thing on his probation forever, and he's just been can't think of the word right now. Can't think of a word. He's just been doing the wrong shit. He's convinced in his mind that it has to do with relationships when it doesn't. The only thing probation cares about with relationships is that the people he's talking to on the phone aren't underage, because that's against his charge. I don't have it on me ready, but if you go to Patrick's channel, Patrick TCAP Ireland, I think he read it in Lauren voice. I'm pretty sure he did that one. Misconstruing. Thank you. Parking lap on it.
This is just
sad. How so sad that you constantly just try to find shit to put me down, Jamie.
This is just sad.
Very sad.
Yeah.
So fucking sad. It's just sad, right?
So
you told your class about us, right?
Oh man.
Yep.
Yep.
That was very confident.
Yep.
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 He didn't go and there was only three people. His best friend. Because he doesn't want face-to-face relationships. So sad.
So sad.
Unbelievable. I try to keep you too informed and you just want to find something negative.
You're the one who started an argument.
That was a liar. Yep.
You two are the ones that started favoring each other.
By the way. Bitch.
Yeah, I've been called a moron, a retard, an idiot.
It's okay. Remember when he tried to get you to break up with me by calling me ugly?
Yeah.
And then asked for pictures?
Yeah,
I've been called a moron, a retard.
Yeah, he's like, hey, you're ugly. Can you give me a photo?
Yeah, I've been called a moron, a retard, an idiot.
It's okay. Remember when he tried to get you to break up with me by calling me ugly? And then asked for pictures? Sloan, why did you say I was ugly? What were you trying to do?
Don't know. I don't even remember it.
If you want me to send pictures again, I need to understand why you did that if you don't think I'm ugly.
Yeah, that is... Tell her the truth, Sloan.
I think she's mad at you.
Remember a few days ago when he said I made a mistake of choosing you over him and said it wouldn't last?
I remember that.
Even though none of that happened.
You were mad, so you said I was ugly?
Yep.
And there's Three's Company.
And there's Three's Company. Ben and Alana. Oh, another debut for you guys right here. You'll look a little different next time you see him, but...
Oh, okay, you can't get but hurt about names then, Lore. I was mad.
Yep.
I try not to get hurt by you guys calling me names. I figure you're just venting.
Well, everyone thinks it's the creature. That would have been good.
You gotta understand where we're coming from. I've never had to deal with someone this stupid before.
It's the internet. He's in Matrix colors.
He'll look more like the internet later.
Yeah, he'll glow instead, but...
Like, put yourself in my shoes.
Word's worst enemy.
I'm just saying, put yourself in my shoes.
Yeah.
Sheesh.
And mine.
The world may never know. It's,
I don't like calling two names. I don't like that shit.
Then why do you do it? We got Blue Cane, Green Cane. The internet.
I can't help it. I'm trying to get out of it. I'm trying to get out of being that way.
You've been trying to get out of it since Ramona.
I'm trying to get out of being that way with you too.
You just have no self-control.
I've got self-control. But.
But.
You don't.
It's kind
or
of
you
been,
have no control.
It's kind of been ruined.
You have zero.
Because of
class.
Because of the Church of Cards bullshit.
Right.
It's not soon. It'll be the next pay per view.
Right, Jamie. You've known that's been my problem the whole time we've been together.
What have they even been doing to you? Ever since I've known you, they haven't, like, showed up and done anything to you.
The Church of Cards really hasn't done anything to him other than like this YouTube stuff, which he can just ignore it,
right? Rash is the mass priest. Even when it was just the robot, like the most the internet did was send him a dildo, send him some magazines, but like what is that doing to him? He just can ignore it.
Yeah,
he can throw it in the
he
garbage
does. He just, for the most part, he just throws that stuff away.
Yeah, so like other this is what he's trying to say is he hates that he's being mocked on the internet. I think he doesn't like looking like a fool, even though he is, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I guess that's what he means? All these people shit-talking on the internet? He wants them to stop.
good luck with that.
Yeah, that's, I mean, bro, you've done enough in one, when you went to Bowling Green, to just ridicule you for life, but all the other shit, it's just extra.
Judge on Gordon, yeah, why you just called me a bitch?
I just don't understand you're blaming this Church of Cod people, but I've known you for 3 months and I've never, like, encountered any Church of Cod nonsense.
Or, like, yeah, the don't. Church of Cod's why he's calling Casey and Jamie right. bitches.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. If the Church of Cod would just all continue to not contact me, then I would not call you a bitch. Green Cane is the internet.
Like, are they going to your house every day and, like, calling you a pedophile? What are they doing to you on a daily basis that's right. causing you to be a little bitch?
None of the things that they sent to me.
Yeah, you just called me a bitch and that's the Church of Cod's fault.
A George Glass.
I talk to you all the time, George.
Yeah, come on, George. Baby, come on.
Why wasn't I?
You know about them sending things to me?
See, I get stupidity.
But what does them sending things you have to do with anything? You just don't respond to them.
Right, that's pretty that's solid advice.
Yeah.
Just don't throw it in the garbage.
Right. Just throw it in the garbage and don't even, I mean, they like, won't even know you reacted to it. You yeah. know what I mean?
Don't answer the mail.
Right.
I don't know.
And what does it have?
And then you get this stupid shit. I'm going to go back, even though he just said one word. He does, every time he just say something that's common sense, ignore it, you get this.
I don't know.
And what does it have to do with Jamie and I?
Oh, no. Well, if you knew, then why didn't you talk about it?
He ignores his bills. Why can't he just ignore the stuff he gets from
taxes? What's that? But the internet?
You're making this perfect pod. Thing, like bigger than it is. It sounds like a group of like just a handful of people. You're not like a minority. Right. You're not just not a hate group. They hate you in their group in that sense, I guess. But they're not like a hate group. They're not racist.
Even my lawyer said he went online.
That's like one.
Your lawyer's a retard. Right.
I was like, well, Falcor's a racist, but that's only one of them.
He can't even get you out of class. He's fucking stupid.
Barry Donahan said, the sting of 2007 for Warren in the summer of 92 for Kevin Nash. That's speaking in tongues right there.
I wasn't born yet.
I don't even... the sting of 2007 for Warren. Wasn't he in, like, teenager in 2007? Well, anyways, thank you, Barry. I appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
What did Blue Boy say? I missed it.
This is the stupidity we are talking about.
Robot just jabbing him one time.
I don't want to be like that with you two. I don't want to. I've never wanted to be like that with you, Jamie.
Oh.
I don't
want to
be that way either. I don't want to call you names.
You never meant to do it.
I don't want to be mad at you all the time. I don't want you to be stupid. I don't want to do it.
Yeah,
things happen
to do this.
That don't make sense to me.
Yeah.
At all. Period. At all.
What? Periods? Like, you don't know how periods work?
Casey, he never meant to do it.
I was on fire.
You know, periods work.
Some of these jokes aren't very good, but...
Can you give an example, Lorne?
Yes, I'm trying to. Jamie, like, as much as Will has been around you,
what?
And you being naked in front of him, you knowing that it's always bothered me and you continuously did it anyway.
Jesus.
Shit like that.
What does that have to do with anything that was talking about? We'll just
get out of nowhere.
You know this for a fact, Jamie. That's the stuff that Winnie used to do.
It didn't happen continuously, moron.
Well, if are you saying Jamie's, like, catfishing you?
Okay, yeah, this is good.
No, Jamie's just being Jamie,
yes.
The way Jamie is.
No, Jamie's just being who Jamie is.
Yeah, that's just the way Jamie is, that's right.
That's
so,
just the way it is.
And Lorne hates the
yeah,
way I am.
Yeah, you don't like it.
No, I don't hate the way you are, Jamie. I hate that you don't hear what... I hate the way that you don't hear what I'm saying. And Casey, stop trying to get her against me.
I find it funny that Jamie can't speak, laugh, anything, but she can cry. Count of three, donate and said, now Blue Boy headshot leaks.
That's not only, my headshot.
OnlyFans when. That's you, right?
No, exactly, that's Baloney Truck. He's a comedian.
What? I heard that was
I'm like, I look the complete opposite of that man.
You look just like
him. You've been doing that since day one.
Then, oh my, if I've been doing it since day one, then why haven't you left?
Question.
Because I believe in you too. I believe in Jamie and I believe in you.
Believing in people.
But it doesn't mean that you two are doing this, doing things right to me. Because you're not.
Jim broke the internet. Thank you, by the way, count of three.
Jamie, it's okay.
Oh, Jamie.
I know.
Jamie, you know I don't. Jamie, you know I don't hate you. You know I love you.
It's the internet.
Yeah, she's doing it since day one. I've been sticking around for 2 years. Is that leaving?
Right. He's so fucking stupid. It's just words. It's just words.
Yeah.
So I'm going to start crying?
You have a funny way of showing it, Lauren.
Yeah. They bullied him for the past hour and he believes in them. I mean, I think they're being very straightforward with Lauren in this call. He's stupid. He's 87. Roscoe.
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Is it too early to ask what's going on for Lornimas this year?
Thank you, Monique. Appreciate it. I don't know. I'm going to be honest with you. I kind of did Lornimas in July. And I don't, honestly, I've forgotten a lot of the calls, so I don't even know what a banger is.
Yeah.
So, we'll see. I'm sure I'll find
we'll
something.
We'll try to find something good.
Yeah. Appreciate it, though. Thank you so much.
Yeah, well, I'll be in prison by then, so.
Well, yeah, I mean.
We can all hang out.
77 days left, guys. Less than. It could happen tomorrow. It could happen in 76 days. But you're fucked. You're fucked, Steven. Jamie's crying for some unknown reason. I've done the math, 87% free to blue player banger.
I'm such a bad person.
No, you're not.
No, you're not a bad person, Jamie.
Bad person.
You're a really good person.
I'm getting off the fucking phone.
Oh.
Casey seems really concerned.
Yeah, no.
Man, I just cannot. I'm not good with emotions.
No, I mean, hey.
I am like a robot. Oh no.
Oh no. Don't
death
go.
Baby?
Don't go. Such a bad person.
I did something today. You might get mad.
Oh god.
What did you do? What is it?
I got your...
I don't know what this says to you.
I got your name tattooed on me.
No, you didn't.
Lauren?
Yes.
You can't believe it.
Listen to him. Hold on, I'm gonna crank him up. Fuck you, Lauren.
Yes.
That one hit him.
What? Why'd you do that?
Why would you do that?
Did you really?
Because I love you that much.
You can get more agitated.
He's always wanted Jamie to act like this to him.
This is...
Where is it?
Sorry, wrong window. Yeah, this is exactly what Lauren wants. He wants his name tattooed on someone.
Yeah.
Someone. He wants to be called, you know, baby and all that shit. Where is it? I know where it is.
Somewhere Lauren can't get a picture of it. That's
no,
sure.
You didn't.
That's right.
It's under my boob.
Oh, it's under her boob. She can't under your bra? She can't show a picture of under her bra. Oh no. Her tits are gonna get in the way and Morton's gonna get
Why
in trouble.
Why'd you do that?
Oh my god.
Why is he mad?
Because he's jealous.
Well, that's true, but...
I mean, I'm flattered. I see it.
Because it's close to my heart, wink wink.
Aww. Aww, you cornball.
Well, that's...
Yeah, something gazing
Can I see it, though? What does it look like?
What does it look like? Well, it's your name. It says Casey in
Casey's
letters.
A fucking idiot.
Let it heal more and I'll show you.
Do you really need
okay.
to
You didn't have to do that.
I wanted to.
I don't even know how long they've known each other at this point.
Not very long.
It's not long enough for that.
What's so funny?
Oh, fucking.
This is before they were. She was extorted by Will and Jamie.
In the story,
in
yes.
the story, yes. And even then, I don't. You know. Because she has to go visit them to be. Before
yeah.
that happens. Lauren's gonna pop his top here. I don't know if he. I don't remember.
I think he does.
2 years with her and she. Never. One tattoo my name. One month of June, she's tattooed.
Well,
my
in
name.
Her defense, your name is hideous.
Yeah, right.
It is.
It is.
I mean, Morn? What kind of name is that?
Don't like
name
me.
That.
Tell me to go fuck myself.
Okay, go fuck yourself.
That just means that you want me to leave.
Because I don't like your name?
Okay, yeah, like, what?
Whatever.
You didn't choose it, it's not your fault. I can't blame
oh,
you for the
name. Christ.
What's the matter now?
Yeah, what is the matter? What's the issue, baby tissue?
She has
what did I do?
This is baby boy in full swing. It's...
What?
What did I do?
What did I do?
What happened?
That's your time machine.
He said it doesn't make sense. I don't know what he's talking about. I didn't do anything.
You tell him you're gonna cheat on me.
Stop upsetting Casey Law.
Now he's stewing. He's starting to think.
Is the cogs are turning?
What are you doing, Lauren?
Thinking.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. You want us to let you go so you can think, or what?
That's up to you.
I hated the shit because he's not thinking. He's just he wants you to be.
Lauren,
concerned.
What's wrong? What's wrong?
Yeah,
Lauren,
and
it's
that's
okay.
When I'm like, okay, you want us to go? And then he's like,
yeah.
No, it's up to you.
I put a tattoo of you on me too, Lauren. It's
yeah.
on the bottom of my foot, like Woody.
Okay, we'll just sit here then until you're done.
Yeah.
What are you thinking about?
Thinking about why everything seems so fucked up.
Well, explain. We're in a relationship, so let's talk about it. What's so fucked up?
What's fucked up is the way that Jamie's been acting ever since day one.
Ever since day one.
It's fucked up that you two have been completely against me since day one.
Yeah. Okay, two things. When he says Jamie was against him from day one, he means the throuple, just so you know.
Okay.
It's confusing. But I think he's talking
Don't
about the
say
throuple.
Anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
I can thank you enough for all the laughs. Much love for the two of you.
Thank you, love.
Thank you.
Now, he's saying that that Casey was against him from day one, too. But if that's the case, let's say if the, even if it was Jamie from the beginning, both of them have been against him from day one. why would he even humor them? Like, if I was dating someone and they were against me from day one, I wouldn't even, like, I'd be like, get out of here.
Yeah.
Why are you with me? Like, you're against me from day one. I don't know how to put it better. It's just, I don't know. Let's finish.
I haven't been against you since day one. You and I got mad at Jamie the other day for Rod. You didn't say that we were teaming up on her.
Got him.
It's because you do the most fucked up things most frequent, so maybe it seems that way.
Is it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is it what?
Don't say anything bad about Will. He's sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I can see his fucking cock.
And it is a sweet pic, let me tell you.
Thank you, Ramona Stiefer. Appreciate it. I wouldn't know. I've never seen it. anyways, let's play this again.
Is it what?
Is it just me?
Yes. Well, sort of.
You have to understand something. Lord only sees what others do to him.
Oh, okay. Oh.
It's true.
So there's no point in trying to explain this to him?
This is me trying to figure out exactly what's going on.
With what?
You're right, Isaiah. It is.
Because none of it makes sense.
Well, what doesn't make sense? You keep saying that, and then you're just saying, oh, because Jamie's the way she is. What's not making sense?
Doesn't make sense.
He doesn't realize you two ganged up on me multiple times, but he says it's always him. Shit like that.
It doesn't make sense why you two are constantly against me. It doesn't make sense that Jamie's been acting this way to me since day one.
He's just repeating what he said.
Yeah.
He's not explaining anything. The call, the don't know sound is from a call that's not out, but it's during Will's amnesia fit. It'll come out eventually.
Which is only 2 months after she told me she loves me, because she didn't want me to go to you.
See how he's saying day one, but now he's just only talking about
it means the throuple.
The throuple.
She just talked both of those things away, stupid.
No, she didn't.
She did.
She did.
When we ganged up on her about Rod, that is automatically null and void half the conversation.
Yeah, so we're not just always ganging up on Lauren.
Yeah.
Yes, she did.
Well, I did, and you clearly didn't hear it, so I'm not even going to say anything anymore.
See?
All I'm going to say is if you're unhappy and you think something's up or wrong, then, you know, go ahead and leave. No one's going to force you. And that'll be your choice, and I will respect it.
I think this is a good example of, like, presenting Lauren with, we don't give a shit, leave, we don't need this.
Yeah.
And he chooses to keep going.
I think it kind of confuses him because he's probably used to people like trying to fight for
him. No, Lauren. Yeah. Just fucking go, bro. And he still won't.
Yeah.
He just wants to feel needed, mm-hmm. is what it is.
But if you're like trying to insinuate that we're like pulling some kind of prank on you, then you're wrong. And if you think that, then you should leave them because it shows you don't trust us. And
that's not,
if you don't trust the person you're dating,
I trust you guys, but
you're fucking
something
with
seems
me.
Fucked up here.
Then you don't trust them. Like,
it's one of those things. I don't get what he wants them to say.
I think it's just one of his games where it's like he just wants to hear out loud them say, "No, Lauren, we love you, and we're not fucking with you." No,
yeah.
And then he goes, "Okay, I'm good until the next problem."
Well, if I know it's not what you want to think, but if it's what you do think, then you can look after yourself.
It's the way that you two are acting.
Look, Casey on
I know.
She do. Goodbye, I'm playing video games.
Hold on, Jamie.
I'm over him now.
You keep saying it's the way we're acting. If we're acting some way you don't like or that you think means we're like pulling some kind of game on you, then go and then leave. Then there's no one like, if someone was messing with me, or I thought you guys were messing with me, I would just leave, because I don't want to be messed with.
Great but advice. If
you don't think we're messing with you, I just don't understand what you mean. You're like, I need to think. Think about what? Just be honest, you think that the way we're acting is like your little catfish people. Is that what you're saying?
Warren, comment.
Yes, that's you what you're saying, in, right? I'm not
you
mad.
You didn't act, Casey. You didn't act this way to me, like this to me before.
Pretty sure she did.
Yeah, and then I got to know you better and figured out that you're like a crazy asshole.
I feel the thruffle. I feel the thruffle. Then it came on very quickly.
Yeah, you showed your true colors very quickly. And if that's why you're saying I'm messing with you, then go ahead and go away. We're only new or catfishing you or whatever.
Capoletta's go
so
away.
If you think I am, then it's in your best interest to stop talking to me.
Then tell me why you two are constantly going against me and all completely favoring each other.
It's
with just about everything.
So Casey laid down it pretty thick there and was pretty honest and gave him options of what he should do going forward with these feelings, and his response was, I need more information.
Yeah.
It certainly is George Glass.
Holy fuck.
This call go up on the Blue Boys channel.
Yahoo user.
Holy fuck.
Because Casey's pretty on fire in this call, so.
Fuck. Because Jimmy's gonna say holy fuck
Warren,
because
shut the fuck
something
up for
that
a second. Well, because it doesn't make any sense. We have got on Jamie for the Rod stuff together. We're not always favoring each other, and her and I get along better than like you and her or you and I do. It's just a fact of the way our relationship is. Jamie and I are just closer than you are with us two. Maybe it's because we like to play video games together, so we get to spend more time together. Or, you know, she's nice to me. She's never called me an ugly bitch.
That usually helps.
Yeah.
That's it.
Don't insult him.
In a three-way relationship, you're not going to feel exactly the same way for each individual person.
Right, but you two are literally attacking me on everything.
Oh my god.
Did you just hear me?
You still attack me on that.
He did not.
Lorne has been playing plenty of games, breaking up with someone and trying to get the other girl to leave with him. Then comes back and says, pretend it didn't happen. That stuff couldn't possibly play into it.
I could sneeze and you two would attack me on him.
Well, if you feel that way, then why do you want to be with us?
He didn't listen to any of
because
that.
Because I don't think I'm doing that.
I love
I'm
you
not
both.
Attacking
Jamie...
you for sneezing.
When we first started this, I was still confused. I was very confused. Because I didn't know how you two would get along. Which I'm happy as hell that you get along great.
He threatens to leave Lorne. Us or you.
But I was also very confused because of the way I feel for Jamie. And Casey, my feelings are growing for you. So at the beginning,
okay,
it all really got... It all really got very confused for me.
He's just not a listener.
Those are all things you caused, though. We're not making you confused. You make yourself confused because you tell me one thing and then you tell her a different thing. You tell her one thing and then go behind my back and say something else, and then go behind her back and say something else. You told me when we first started you didn't have any feelings for her anymore. And then you're telling her that I'm an ugly bitch, and then you just think you can take those things back. And we should just forget it because he said sorry.
When we first got together, I didn't tell you I didn't have feelings for her anymore. I told you the opposite.
Oh,
I told you that
right.
I still have feelings.
You told me you didn't love her anymore. You have. You told me that.
Yeah.
I have text messages
Yeah, that was that was when we first got together.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, is that you say one thing, and then you say a different thing, and that's the reason you're confused. It's because you don't...
Good Lord.
You said you were completely done with her, and then we get in this ruffle, and you're, like, all in love with her again. And then 2 weeks ago, you call me, like, a pathetic bitch. You call Jamie fake the other day, and then in the same day, you say stuff like, oh, I love you guys more than anything. I'll never leave you guys. 15 minutes later, you're threatening to leave again. And then you come to us saying you're confused why we're being assholes. It's because you're bipolar as fuck. Like, I'm just supposed to be nice when you're being a dick to her, or being a dick to me, or saying, like, I'm a bitch, or that I'm ugly, or you're calling her a bitch and she's ugly, or she's fake, or she's Winnie. We're just supposed to forget about it because you say sorry, and 5 minutes later sending gross kisses.
Lauren?
He's like, how do I deflect?
When I'm nice to her and she says something...
Oh, God.
Can you address what I said before, like, changing it to something else, please?
Yeah, I'm addressing it.
No, you're just going back to what you said where Jamie...
Don't say anything bad about Will. He sent me a sweet picture with his pants down so I could see his fucking cock.
Thank God there was no mac and cheese involved. That had put him over the edge.
Right, Platy? Thank you. Now, I'll ask you all, one in the chat for yes, two in the chat for no, do you think that Lauren is going to answer Casey's question in his response, that he is ramping up?
Well, yeah, that's part of addressing it, it's part of what you mentioned.
Alright, go ahead then. What were you going to say? I guarantee you it's the same shit you just said.
So when I'm nice to her, And she calls me fucking names and shit right after I'm nice to her. How am I supposed to react to that?
Now that doesn't Happy? Address anything she just said, who would have thought?
Yeah, of course I'm it talking about how you behave, Lauren, why you're confused. And you're changing it to Jamie calling you names when you're nice. I don't... Can you stick to one thing? We're talking about one thing and then we'll move on to that.
How I'm confused.
So you know he decides
one way
to
that
answer.
I'm confused right. is why
you
didn't Jamie
to yourself.
How can I say anything when I just get interrupted by her all the time?
She has now, the speaker thing, Lauren.
I would just like to point out that Jamie had said a few things before this and he plowed over it and ignored it. I just
how can I say anything when I just get interrupted by her all
the
time?
She has the speaker thing, Lauren. How do you not realize after 2 years it's on a delay?
Yeah, but she's done that to me a lot on intentionally.
Lauren, you've gone over me twice already and ignored what I said.
Alright, Lauren, what were you gonna say?
Fuck, now I forgot.
Must not have been that important then.
He had an answer, but he forgot it because they asked him to answer the question.
I can't remember the last question that was asked.
I forgot I what? Need to type at the speed of light.
Oh my God.
You said you're confused because Jamie does something or something. I don't know.
I agree, Jennifer. It was right.
One way that I'm confused. It's because it's been 2 years and Jamie's made no move to come up here. When she did, she wanted to bring Rod.
We've talked about this before. She's even told me you didn't have a job at the time and you couldn't quit smoking. She doesn't have the lung strength or anything to be able to handle your smoke then.
Smoke shop. It's a chicken shack.
How do you not? It's been said to you many times while I've been around. I can only imagine how many times she's told you when you guys were dating before. but it's pretty self-explanatory. She doesn't have, like, the lung strength.
Sorry, Casey.
And if you're upset that she didn't come see you before, then, I mean, you say all the time, don't bring up the past, Jamie. Don't bring up the past. And then here you are bringing up something that was happening before we were in a throuple. That's not relevant anymore. And it was your own fault because you wouldn't quit smoking.
Absolutely. What do you got, Lauren?
And if that's the big deal, that you think she's messing with you or something, and that's why she didn't come up, then don't date her.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa, hold on.
You're telling me I have a choice here?
Listen, there's nothing, there's no such thing as free will in Lauren's world, so don't try and act like he's gonna get one now.
He's quiet for a while.
He's quiet for about a full minute of silence, of just silence, and then this happens.
Are you quiet because you're trying to think of a way to deflect again?
No, I'm not.
87 seconds of silence.
Why are you quiet?
Just thinking.
What are you thinking about?
No, he's not. He's actually not thinking of anything.
Cause... just all kinds of stuff.
Alright, like what?
All kinds of things going on.
God, it's Alex Jones.
Well, okay, what's one of them that you're thinking about?
One of them that I'm thinking about is when I told you about Jamie.
God, what's he gonna say?
What about her?
When I told you about her website. Her,
like, he's sort of like vague. Just spit the whole thing out.
Right, just say what you're thinking. The website. But, like, real quick, I didn't hear what he said, but let's just...
or what her stage name was.
Where is this coming from? What are you talking about?
Exactly. It had nothing to do with the point that was made. It had nothing to do with the conversation at hand. He's like, the stage name.
I'm just thinking of all kinds of things at one time.
Isn't it crazy, ADD, that he doesn't answer the question, but he always says that he does and that they don't? Yeah.
But right here, she's asking him, like, okay, well, let's go over them then, so you don't have these questions anymore.
Yeah.
Like, tell me, let's go through one at a time, tell me what is one of the things about bothering you.
Right.
And then we can work through that, and then we'll go to the next issue you have, so we can stop having this fucking conversation.
Right. So we go through the first issue of her not showing up. He's silent for a minute, and then goes, is stage name on your website?
Yeah, that's so fucking random.
It's just...
okay, what about you telling me what her stage name is?
Well...
being his therapist should be paid, like,
stacks.
$250,000 a year.
This is... I can't imagine what it's like having to try and counsel this man.
How into it you were right off the bat.
Notice the one thing he isn't thinking about.
The question that was asked?
I was into her off the bat. She's hot. What's your point?
You were into her right off the bat.
Same time, I'm thinking about how she... had your email the whole time. How she was.
For the emails with Casey, he was instantly like,
right.
We should meet.
So he's ping ponging right now. He's just jumping from topic to topic. Now, obviously, he's suspicious, right? He's trying to put the pieces together.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, these things can be talked away. You were into her right away. She was hot. I made that clear. He goes, how Jamie had your email. Lauren forwarded his conversation to Casey to prove that he wasn't flirting and was trying to find a way to forward it with, like, half of it missing.
Yeah.
But he sent the whole thing, and Jamie now had her email. Lauren gave her the email.
And that was explained to him in the past.
Yes.
Casey was like, why are you giving people my email address?
Right. And now he's forgotten all that, and now we have to run through it again. We have to run the gauntlet again because he needs to feel like he's the victim in this whole thing. It's ridiculous.
I was into her off the bat. She's hot. What's your point?
Same time, I'm thinking about how she had your email the whole time, how she was sending you everything that I did.
Because you're being a piece of shit!
Okay, so once again, you're thinking we're in cahoots with each other to mess with you. I'm not gonna keep having this conversation. If you think I'm fucking with you, then fucking leave me alone.
Ooh, nice one.
That's what I want to know, is that you two are not fucking with me.
Oh my god.
How can I prove it? You think, how would that work? You think we planned this entire game?
I just want you to tell me out straight. That there was no fucking bullshit.
He's just turning this with around.
I told you out straight up. I'm turning this around, Jamie. You fucking moron, idiot. How many more fucking times do I need to say it? I told you out straight 100 times that if you think I'm fucking with you, then go away. You can leave. If I was fucking with you, wouldn't I be trying to convince you not to leave? Because I'd want to keep fucking with you. I'm telling you, if you think I'm fucking with you, then stop talking to me. It's that easy for you.
It is a good play, though. Like, at the same time, it's true. It's like, if I wasn't
fucking
you,
if
I wasn't fucking you with you, wouldn't I be telling you that I'm not and telling you to stay? And
yeah.
I'm telling you to go fucking leave? And he's like, shit.
Is that straight out enough for you?
That's straight out enough for you.
Alright, so shut the fuck up now.
Alright, now Jamie, I want to know why you did all this sending bills and shit to Casey.
What does it matter? Because you were... Okay, again, I explained this at the start of the stream for people that just showed up. Lorne was trying to two-time both girls with each other. He said he was going to be with Casey, and then he started messaging Jamie in email saying, your pussy always belongs to me, and I'm still in love with you. And he's like, why did you send those emails to her telling her that I was two-timing him?
Yeah.
Like, god damn. I mean, you're right. Like, why wouldn't you admit that you're fucking with somebody? But Catchy donated and said, I so appreciate the hard work the both of you do. Thank you. Thank you, Catchy.
You.
George Glass, this is my new boyfriend. Thank you for the saying that. That's really nice.
Holy shit.
Holy shit, what? I ask you a question and you say, holy shit, I don't want to answer it?
It's been answered! Yeah.
What emails are you talking about?
I think the robot was being ignored and at this point, like, having to answer these
you're
stupid questions.
Pissed off.
Yeah, it's just, it was like, the robot's about to shut down and reboot or something, because this is ridiculous.
Her emailing you when you and I first got together.
You haven't answered one fucking question Casey asked you.
You're talking about the time where you were telling me that...
ADD, thank you for pointing out that he still hasn't answered the question that was asked of him, and he's asked, like, 14.
You didn't like her anymore. And you were over her, and it was just me and you. And all your attention was on me now. Meanwhile, you were texting her.
I'm over here now.
The exact same stuff while she had a boyfriend. So she was telling me to warn me about you being a two-timing liar.
There it is.
That's another thing, too, Jamie.
it doesn't address it at all.
Doesn't address why it makes perfect sense for them to email him. Another thing. Let's just deflect from that now. I gotta look better.
Jesus.
We'll address this thing first before
we move
on. Yes,
thank you, Casey.
That's your fault you had to send those to me. If you didn't try to do that, if you didn't try to be a two-time and snake lying bitch, then there would have been nothing for her to send to me.
There's a bunch of silence. There's
silence because he's thinking.
Lauren's trying to think of a new excuse to not look like a piece of shit. He's silent for 18 seconds.
That was 100% your fucking fault.
Oh look, it's Lorne's fault yet again, but I'm the bad guy. I need to answer questions.
Yeah, exactly. Lorne, it was your fault.
It was my fault.
Oh my god, I lose my mind.
Yeah, so why are you mad at Jamie for sending me emails when it was stuff that you did? That you did wrong?
Because it doesn't make sense to me why she would send you emails.
It was just explained.
It was just explained for the past 2 minutes why the emails were sent, and he just... Right here. Hold on. Right here. What?
It was my fault.
He just admitted, and then 2 seconds later, it's...
I need to check my blood pressure right now.
I know. I think I'm going to...
It doesn't make sense to me why she would send you emails.
I can't... This is how people... Okay, guys. I know that probation sucks, right? But if you had to deal with this day in, day out, would you give a shit after a while? I would give up.
I would give up. I think we give up towards the end of this.
Yeah. I'll say this. During the time that this all went down, with the robot at least. Lorne had, I think, 3 or 4 probation officers in that time. And 2 of them at least came in and were like, Lorne, I'm on your side. I believe you. You know, there's no way you're lying to me, dude. There's no way. And they tried to help him. And what happened? They both quit. They both said, fuck this, I'm out. Give him to somebody else. I can't deal with this. Because this is what you deal with day in and day out.
Because she's a good person and you're a bad person. Because he told me the bad stuff you were doing. Wouldn't you want to know if I was telling you I loved you all the time? Sorry, Jamie.
She just explained it. Holy shit, open your ears, Lorne.
But wouldn't you like it, Lorne, if someone were to tell you, they emailed you saying that OKC has, she's in another trouble with 2 other people? Wouldn't that be something you'd want to know? That's what Jamie was doing. She wasn't lying to me. She's being honest.
So it had nothing to do, Jamie, it had nothing to do with you being mad at me because I chose Casey.
That's what he wants it to be so bad.
Instead of you.
He
even
wants
after
it to be jealous.
My mom says this is a fucking idiot.
Holy fuck, see, she won't stop with the goddamn names.
Well, because I know the answer to this. She's told you before. She had a boyfriend. She wasn't trying to make you jealous.
Yeah. But I just don't get it. I don't know why this is even a conversation. I mean, again, it was just, he was just walked through it again as to why this all happened. And he still is like, no, it's the way I want it. I think it's jealousy, so it's got to be jealousy.
Oh,
she likes her boyfriend. She likes Rod. He said it 100 times. So she's getting frustrated because we have this conversation every other fucking day.
Yep. Casey, she did not have a boyfriend when she started doing that.
God.
And she did not like Rod when she started doing that. No, you did not.
This is another thing. Lorne thinks that, like, just because, you know, Jamie may not have liked Rod at the beginning, she couldn't like him later on, just like she liked Lorne in the starting and didn't like him later on. Feelings don't change. They're permanent.
I don't get how you're working with her without having a boyfriend. She would know if she had a boyfriend. How can you say no?
I knew she didn't have a boyfriend.
She knows that she did.
She started doing that right off the bat because she told me that she was going to send you everything that she had.
Okay,
everything
I'm done
that
with
I
this.
Said.
He just wants to be right. I'm going to do something else.
Okay.
This is Paula.
You wonder why we get frustrated because you can't get anything through your head.
She never had any interest in Rod before, either.
And then she did. You don't understand people's feelings can change.
Okay. When I asked her if she told Rod that she was in love with me, she kept saying no. And I kept asking her if it was Rod, and she kept saying no.
She didn't say no. She just didn't answer. For those listening at home.
Answer the same fucking 4 months on end, but I'm told I'm wrong and haven't answered it.
Maybe she said no because she knew you were going to react like this. Because you're her ex-boyfriend, so she didn't need to owe you an explanation. You don't think of these common sense things.
Maybe it was none of your business.
When relationships end, people tend to move on.
Amanda James is now on the roster. There's now another 18 seconds of silence.
And if you were broken up, I don't see why it matters who she was dating.
Because she knew that I hated Rod.
Yeah, but you're her ex-boyfriend, so why does it matter to her? Or to you?
You left me, so what I do and who I date is none. I repeat, none
exactly.
of your business.
That's because he's been getting double-teamed and just, like, sand pounded up his ass, whatever horseshit flown up his ass the whole fucking call.
So she's not supposed to date, or anyone of your ex-girlfriends, because he's supposed to date someone you don't like? That makes no sense, you're her ex. You can't dictate what she does after you break up with her.
Oh, it just seems odd that she was dating the one person that she knew I hated.
Why?
Okay.
Okay, well then it seems odd. whatever then.
Mora doesn't have a dollar sense or common sense.
I mean, she didn't hate him, that's the point. You hated him, she did not hate him.
Resetting that headset.
I can't wait to answer these questions a week from now, and be told I haven't answered them.
Right. By God, Lauren doesn't have a family.
Jimmy, it all depends on how you're gonna act, do you know?
Oh, for God's sakes.
I don't just up and act this way for no reason at all.
Back to blaming me.
Yeah.
Look at how you presented yourself ever since we started this throuple.
Back to blaming me.
It's like you don't realize you have the power to break up with her if you don't like it.
I don't want to break up with you two.
Then shut the fuck up.
Well, I want the different bullshit to stop.
Well, it's not gonna stop, okay? It's not gonna stop. So now what do you want to do?
Well, if it doesn't stop, there's no telling what I'll do.
Okay.
There's now another 14 seconds of silence.
Stop and think about how fair you two are being to me. You're favoring each other, and you're ganging up on me. Holy shit. Of course you don't want to think about that. That would be terrible to think about, wouldn't it, Jamie?
We're going to keep acting the way we act, because that's our personalities. We're going to keep acting the way to each other that we want to.
You don't hear that.
And if you want to leave, go ahead, okay?
Okay.
Now, can we stop having this conversation?
Yeah, we can, because I'm gonna stick with it until we actually give this a fair chance in person.
Then what the fuck has the last hour been about? Holy shit, I'm gonna lose my mind. Oh my god.
Okay, great. So, if you wanna be all butthurt that I'm favoring her, she's favoring me, just remember, you can do whatever you want, you can leave if that upsets you, and that'll be your choice, okay?
All right, just remember, I don't expect you two to treat me like an asshole.
All right, well, noted.
Understand, Jamie?
He acts like he has, like, the power here.
Yeah, like, he somehow just took control of everything. He's like, listen, guys, you're going to listen to me.
When did this get flipped around? You have nothing.
That's a good one, Mike. So come knock on Lauren's door.
Well, if you're, like, trying...
He'll be yelling at you.
...trying to threaten something, I really could care less. If you're, like, threatening that I'm doing something or you're going to leave me,
no.
You might get...
There's no threat about it. I want you to understand, I don't want to be treated like an asshole.
Well, stop
then
being...
stop being an asshole.
Thank you, Casey.
I'm going to stop being an asshole.
Okay, great, then I won't treat you like an asshole.
All right, Jamie, how about you?
Oh, God. Oh, my God, dude. Tiffany did the J-O-B, that's right.
Is she even there?
I mean, I'm pretty sure the robot shut down about 5 minutes ago when this horse shit kept going on.
Oh, wait a second. No, he's not.
No. Mr. Questionnaire, the internet, and Carter debuted tonight.
She's not there?
He's not here. He hung up.
I wonder why she hung up. I mean, it's been an hour of the same horseshit.
I think you really did hang up too. I think you were actually getting pissed during this.
It's just because, like, the robot would say shit and it would just be completely ignored. It was like she was just talking into the void. It was like, alright. And then he'd just keep going back to his old shit, and then after it's been explained to him 100 times, in case he's finally like, just fucking leave. He goes, well, I'm not going to treat like an asshole. And you went, whatever. And yeah, he goes, like, Jamie, what about you?
I don't even want to be treated that way. But if you feel like you are,
yeah,
go it's away. Because they're not going to stop doing what they're doing.
No.
She flat out said that.
Yeah. It's just...
Why would she hang up?
Because you're a fucking idiot.
Well, because we've had this same conversation 100 times. And I keep repeating myself. You keep repeating yourself. So she hung up. She's just frustrated.
I've had this conversation with her a million times because she does the same stuff.
Yeah, that's why she probably hung up then.
blood. This is Lamondre.
She does the same stuff to me, Casey.
Okay.
All the time.
So here's what I'm saying. So she does something. You say, if you do that again, I'm done. And she keeps doing it. And then you go back to saying, I'm going to leave if you do that again. Then she keeps doing it. And then you keep saying you're going to leave and you don't leave.
I don't, because I love her.
Right.
All right. Then you got to deal with the way she is then. She's not going to change her personality for you just because you don't like something. Because you aren't leaving. You aren't going to leave.
But in a relationship, aren't you supposed to be changing for that person that you're with?
No, you should love the person you're with because that's who they are.
I believe Casey's true. In a sense, you know, but I do think that if you're going off Lauren's logic, you need to change for the person you're with.
Yeah.
Why isn't he changed at all?
Well, he doesn't have to do any of that.
Oh, right. He's the man, right?
Well, he's perfect. I mean, he'll change once you get up there, he'll change.
Oh, well, that's it. Okay.
But you gotta change first. So you gotta, he'll quit smoking, even though you can't be around smoke, once you get up there.
Oh, okay. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Now I get it. Okay.
You don't get in a relationship with someone to try to change them. You get into a relationship with them because you like that person.
But if you're doing things that bother the other person, then you try to stop doing that stuff.
Yeah, and if they don't change because they don't want to change, then that's how relationships end.
What? That's crazy.
What?
He's blown away.
Every relationship has ended in the history of existence because someone did something the other person didn't like.
What? This is all silence. I'm not even going to skip this one, but just a couple seconds.
You're acting like...
I know a lot of it's my fault, Casey.
You're acting like being in a relationship means that no one can break up after that. If you keep acting like a screw-up and she keeps being mean to you, then go away and end it.
Things happen that just...
Exactly, bud.
The things that happen with Jamie that you just don't think are going to happen in a relationship. I mean, like another guy being around her and seeing her naked and shit. How often do you see that in a relationship?
Then fucking leave.
With a porn star?
Yeah,
I would say it happens quite a bit.
I'm sure a lot of guys see porn star girlfriends naked a lot. I mean, it's just go back to the talking points. He just wants to hear someone say, you're right, Lauren. I'm guessing.
He just wants to bully them into stopping, but they...
Well, that's it.
He's not hearing anything.
No, it's just, it's all about what he thinks and feels, and he's going to make them... hear what he has to feel, and if they don't agree, then he'll just repeat it.
Yeah, but I mean, he wanted Will in the room, and she was filming porn.
Right, but that's different, I guess.
Then who's he talking about, guys seeing her naked all the time, if it's not Will?
It's Will, but I don't know.
Because besides Will, it's just whoever she's banging, which, I mean, that's the least of your problems.
That's good one. Rod? I don't know. Yeah, you're right.
I mean,
the one-winged angel dog.
That should be an automatic thing. You're in a relationship with another person. You don't go letting another guy constantly see you naked.
That's a relationship
and
advice.
And it's real life. You break up with that person.
The advice show.
You even don't like that.
Yeah, but I trust her, and we've talked about it, and I like her enough that I'm secure with her showing her body for her work.
For her work, that's one thing. But I had to deal with Will seeing her naked all the time.
Yeah, see,
it's
just
they say just one time.
You didn't have to deal with that,
though. Holy moly. This is ridiculous.
You didn't have to deal with that. It was your choice to deal with it.
Another moment of Lauren just being dead silent.
That shit was so hard on me because of what I had to deal with Emma and Winnie and the fucking unbelievable amount of retarded bullshit that they pulled.
Yeah. Okay, once again, you didn't have to deal with it. You didn't have to. You keep saying, I had to deal with this person. I had had to deal with this person doing this thing to me. You didn't have to deal with it. You always have the option to leave.
Yeah, but I didn't want to leave Jamie. I loved her.
Oh, is he gonna start
crying? Well then you deal with it then.
Tears.
And then you can't bitch about it later because you had the option to leave and you didn't take it. So you can't be mad because it's your fault.
Turtle shoe.
If she did something I didn't like, I would leave her. Same goes for you. If you did something I didn't like, I would leave you. That makes perfect sense. That's how relationships end.
Well, we needed a catfish.
So well,
we couldn't leave.
Normally a woman would have been done with him in the first couple of minutes.
Yeah.
But this is also more silence from Lauren.
Like, are you so desperate that you can't leave something that's bad for you?
No, I know Jamie's a good person.
Okay.
Then stop bitching about her.
And that could be it right there. You think you know she's a good person, then you gotta put up with the stuff you don't like about her.
I really don't understand what other options he thinks he has.
And he has none.
Rod's gonna see her naked regardless of if you like it or not.
What? Mark does look like
Corfield. You can leave all you want. And if she's gonna keep doing it and you don't leave, that's your problem.
Oh, thank you, Jennifer.
Same for me. If I'm doing something you don't like and you don't leave, well, sucks to be you then.
Well, she keeps doing it regardless of how we feel about it.
Oh.
She's not at work.
Then leave. Then we can leave then.
How do you
That's her telling,
through this?
Telling us that she doesn't care how we feel.
Right, Lauren.
Exactly.
So you leave that person. That's when you leave.
You don't care how I feel. You leave them.
So when I said you could leave, that's when you would leave.
If you feel like that someone you're dating doesn't care how you feel,
you have the
option to leave. Do you understand?
I understand.
Do you? Because
we're
in an
hour.
Okay,
you understand that. Can you say it to me so I can hear you say it so I know my own sanity that you understand?
I understand that if a person's acting in a way that I don't agree with in the relationship, I have the option to leave.
Yeah.
But the hard part is being in love with that person.
Yeah, no, everything after that is all nonsense right now.
Right.
Yeah, it's hard to leave someone you love, but if they're not doing something that you like, then just leave.
Right.
Break up is hard on everyone. But it's so easy to leave if they're not... First of all, you haven't met her, so it's easy to leave. And second of all, if it's so terrible, everything she does is terrible, then leave.
This is for the State of Maine Championship.
Jamie texted us, I have some thinking to do.
That's a Lauren move.
Okay.
Lauren does that shit when in the throuple a lot.
Can you blame her?
She also said that just because I say that.
That is a good one, Joyce.
Okay, well, if that's what you think, then whatever.
I'm texting her back. I wish you could get back on the phone with us.
Why? So you can ask the same fucking three questions over and over again?
And maybe she'll make the choice to leave. I mean, you realize how beautiful she is, right? You can get anyone she wants. I think you take that for granted. Granted. You should be grateful.
No, I don't. I don't take that for granted. But being beautiful doesn't mean that you do whatever the fuck you want to people.
It kind of does.
And act however you want and think that they're not going to be affected by it.
They don't give a shit if you're affected by it.
It's just taking advantage of another person's feelings. Just because you think you're so beautiful that you can get away with shit.
Well, I think when you look like a gremlin and you're dating a supermodel, you should put up whatever she wants to do.
Right.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Alright. Lauren, damage control time. Let's hear it, bud.
I have been thinking so hard.
Jamie, hold on. I love you so much.
Aww. This is true love.
Oh, I love you too, babe.
And Lauren's like, I love you too, and just kissing
I love you too, Jamie. You know I love you.
Shut up.
Whatever.
See?
Two.
That's the response that I get.
And leave her.
Jamie, you make me happier than I've ever been. And
sad.
I love playing games with you. And I think you're funny and smart.
I meant every word of this report.
Oh, thanks, bud.
You make me feel the same way, babe.
And so is the robot, you know? Oh, awesome, VJ. Okay, so I think Jamie's typing right now. There's silence. I'm not even going to time this part, but...
I've loved you since day one.
No, we're okay. Trying to do it, too.
Okay, all right, hold on. You know what? Okay, I'm going to roll this back a little bit, and we're going to listen to the silence in full. Hold on.
Jamie, you make me happier than I've ever been. And I love playing games with you. And I think you're
Fortnite?
Funny and smart.
You make me feel the same way, babe.
They're having a moment. And
yeah. Lauren's sitting there with his coffee going... Or he's getting a hard on. One of the two. I mean, I don't fucking know. He's sniffing. This is all real time, guys. This is nothing is being skipped right now. And
I've loved you since day one, Jamie.
Since day one, is that it? He said earlier she's been a bitch.
I don't ever want to stop loving you.
Right, and I've never stopped.
I don't want to be an asshole to you.
Aww, he's gonna fix this, guys. They're gonna get back to you.
Lauren, shut up for a second.
Oh, man. Lauren, shut up. I got something to say, you bitch. Okay.
Lauren's long, okay, this long silence.
This time, Jamie's typing, and, okay, here we go.
Casey, I think we have a special connection. I haven't felt this way about anyone. You are my everything. I think about you all the time. I wish I could sing to you. Casey, will you marry me?
That answer really goes.
Are you serious?
I just have no acting ability coming up here.
Yeah, go back to. Wow.
Are you serious?
Hold on. What are you talking about, dude? This is 100% standard.
No, marry me.
Right here.
This part right here.
Are you serious?
No, hold on, it's coming up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, gotcha.
It's embarrassing every time I hear
Dead
it.
Dead serious.
Dead serious. Oh, yeah. Aw.
Oh, my God. Yes. Yes, I'll marry you.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
I love it so clearly.
Yes. Yes, I'll marry you. No, that
there's no emotion behind it at all.
There's no emotion. Yes. Yes, I'll marry you. I mean, I felt it. Did you guys feel it out there? Come on. You felt it. You know who else felt it and thought this was all genuine and real? Lauren.
Oh my God.
I love you so much. Yes. Of course, yes.
There's no way Lauren's not happy for his two girlfriends getting engaged, right?
Yes. I love you, babe.
I love you too. I love you so much.
Let's pop a little. Let's get a little bit of the bubbly. It's a celebration, bitches.
Yes, Jamie. I love you so much.
Yes, Jamie. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my
yes,
God.
I will marry you.
I think
yes.
There's a part two where you're like, hey, I call my mom.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Lauren, we're married. So we're engaged. I mean, no, dude, this is great.
God, I can't wait to see you. I got you a ring.
I mean, have you heard the robot emoting
emotion? She already got her a ring, too.
She got her a ring. They've been dating for a month, okay? A month, right?
You yeah. Got me a ring.
Okay. Now, you can kind of hear in the background, but Lauren's starting to rustle around. And
You got me a ring already. How long were you thinking about this for?
I always think of Nathaniel like going, long time, Lauren.
A couple days.
A couple days, that's enough time to think about it.
Hey, you know, I got your name tattooed under my boob and I got a ring and thought, hey, this is the... After Lauren berated us for an hour over the same stupid questions, I thought, this is the time I gotta ask if we can get married.
Can't wait to call my mom.
Wedding celebration next week on A7. No, wrestling weddings never end well.
Oh my god.
I just can't. Shut up, Casey.
I have tears streaming down my face. This is very moving.
Oh my god, I'm so happy.
I think she's happy.
Can't you tell?
Alright, Lauren, what do you got?
Lauren, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
I'm shaky.
So moved.
Just so romantic.
I'm floored.
Easy not to cut you.
Sorry. I'm floored.
I'm floored.
Easy not to cut you off. I know you are so excited as I am, but we have to be fair. Lauren, what were you saying?
Anyways, Lauren, what do you got?
Oh, okay.
I don't remember.
Are you happy for us?
No, I am happy for you. I'm fucking floored.
Me too.
There's a turn here, I think.
I wasn't expecting that tonight.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, it does take a turn here.
I'm leaving the silences in now, guys.
Be free. I didn't think she'd say yes, but I went for it.
Uh-oh. I think I hear some sniffles.
Lauren, will you walk us down the aisle?
Yep.
Yep.
Well, I want my dad to walk me down the aisle.
Yep.
Oh, sorry, babe.
Comment.
Okay, Lauren, what were you saying?
I don't remember.
Got a donation from Westmos. Tell her you have a boyfriend and that it's me. That's probably one of my favorite Lauren lines. That one is second to Paper Thin Walls goodbye recently. Blue Boy, I got your name tattooed around my nipple with a pic of Green Man colored blue. Don't tell Reborn though, unless he's putting on face makeup. Thank you, Wes. I'll let him know.
Well, you told me to call her back. So I did.
Hey, Lauren, what do you got?
I know. I'm floored.
He's speechless of this happening.
What are you floored about?
He doesn't know what to do.
I didn't expect that.
He is in trouble.
Neither was I, but why, what's the matter?
Lauren?
Now that I'm just floored by it.
Well, what's flooring you about it?
What is
you're floored by it too, you didn't expect it either.
Oh yeah, because I was proposed to you. Yeah. Why are you
that
for?
Too, yeah.
I'm just floored by it.
Great explanation.
Yeah, can you explain? This is the thing. You never explain.
Because I can't even get it straight in my head right now.
What about it?
The other thing that happens here is that now I think legally Lauren can't marry either of them because they're marrying each other, right?
I think it's explained, and he has a solution for that as well.
Yes, I think that's a little later on.
Yeah.
Are you okay? What's happening?
Really sucking the happiness and fun out of this.
I'm not really taking any happiness and fun out of it. I'm happy for you. I'm very happy that you get along so good. You feel the way you do about each other.
fight? You sound like you're gasping for air. You having a heart attack?
You have a heart attack?
Yeah.
What's that? Why are you making that sound?
So I'm trying to get out words that I don't even know what the words are.
Well, his voice
I'm
is starting
trying to get out words that I don't even know what the words are.
He just starts going, A-l-l-l-l-l-l.
Yeah, he starts speaking in tongues.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's about to baby boy.
Call me back in.
Call
me back in a few minutes. I need a few minutes to myself.
No, wait. Why are you? No, hold on.
No, Lauren, we need you crying on the camera. Oh,
yeah.
What's wrong?
Hold on. What is going on, Lauren?
Lauren.
I need a few minutes to myself.
No, why? Why? You gotta tell me why.
No,
tell me what's the matter.
He could just hang up. Why is he?
Yeah, right. I don't.
Why are you crying? What's wrong?
It's
a new rule. We need to talk about things. What is wrong?
You are fucking
rude. I don't know yet.
He doesn't know why he's crying.
But we're gonna stay on the phone until we figure it out. You're not hanging up.
I don't know yet.
Why are you crying?
Convert plant. Sorry.
Are you crying because you're sad or because you're happy?
Both.
Why are you crying?
That one be the one to post to YouTube first.
Oh, baby boy.
And
we got
that makes
baby.
Me sad.
That makes me sad because I have. Because everything is. To me so much.
What?
I don't know.
So, you're sad.
I want to be so close to you too, and it's so fucking hard to do.
Yeah, because you suck.
When you're being an asshole.
About
yeah.
Stuff and having probation fucking run their mouths.
Okay.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
And not being face to face with you too, not being able to see you on video, not getting the pictures, not getting.
His list of demands.
Yeah.
So that's why you're sad.
It's just
you
all the things that went on.
I mean, he's not engaged, and all he's thinking about is
himself.
Him not getting pictures and videos.
Yeah. I'm so happy for you guys, but where's my videos?
So, what would hanging up have done for you?
That's a good question.
Just to be able to think alone.
You do that every day, bro.
Well, what are you thinking about? I know you're sad you didn't propose first, but I mean, not really anything we can do about that now.
There's a word that Jamie says to you, a word that I've wanted her to say. And until.
So
she was afraid
man.
That I was going to leave her for you, she didn't say anything.
Dashboard confessional.
At the beginning, she did. But then she didn't say him for a long, long time, so she was afraid I was going to leave her for you.
Is he trying to make her jealous right now?
So, are you saying that, like, you're jealous? That's pretty good.
Oh, yeah, part of me is jealous. Part of me is very jealous. I'm also happy too at the same time because I want you two to feel the way you do about each other.
No, you don't.
But I want you two to feel the way that way about me too. And
yeah,
I know
maybe,
I
and maybe one day we will, but that has to. That starts with you.
It starts with one thing. I have a question for the audience, and this is just a genuine question. I'm not as. I don't have the knowledge of Winnie that I do other stuff, but I feel like from robot start to end, and I mean with Casey, like when the throuple ends, has he cried this much with anyone else?
No.
He cries a lot with the robot.
Yeah.
It's like...
I think because sober Lauren is, he's very sad.
So
drunk Lauren is very angry.
Drunk Lauren's angry and can kind of forget his stupid life for a little while.
Yeah,
but
sober Lauren has to face these things without any sort of mental block.
There's no escape from the, yeah. from the torment. Instead of screaming, he's crying. Yeah, definitely. I mean, trust me, I would have loved the robot to go one-on-one with the Great One, and by that I mean Drunklorn.
Oh my god, Drunklorn against the robot would have been...
Oh man, it would have been...
Oh my god, can you imagine?
It would have been fantastic.
He can barely understand the robot now.
Oh man, he is the cheaters.
Oh, that's true. He cried a lot with Ramona, but I think...
He did cry with Ramona.
He did a healthy bit of both, though, with Ramona.
He did, yeah, drunk... Sober crying, no. Okay. It was a genuine question. I know with Ramona he cried a fair bit, but I don't feel it was near as much as this. Like, I know Lorne was using it as a manipulation tactic at times,
yeah.
but...
It's not part jealousy. It's mostly jealousy.
It's not something you can force. If that's something you want, you gotta work towards it.
No, no, no.
Well, it's upsetting because me and Jamie was there once already.
He was once there.
Nick got lost all the time.
Did it get lost, or did you ruin it?
Hold on, I got a little mental sleep on him. Heads it down.
Okay.
I'm thirsty.
I'm thirsty for your pussy, baby. Yes. Was that silly of me?
You're making me blush.
I know, I'm being silly.
Thirsty for your pussy.
I'm thirsty for your pussy, baby. Alright, guys, we're gonna stop it there for the night. I hope you all had fun. I thought I would cover something before we go.
Okay.
I've heard a lot of speculation on Hannah. And, you know, there's some wild guesses out there. None of them are correct. But I'm just going to tell everyone so that the it can stop, I guess. So that there's no more infighting over who the fuck it is. It was many syllables. So there you go. Everyone guessing people currently, I don't know why you would. But there you go. The Hannah heads out there. There's your answer. That was a frustrating call at times, but also hilarious. We got crying. We got real, like, some top zingers from Casey in that one. Jamie's proposal and tattoo really were low blows to Lauren there. What do you think?
I love that call.
It was good. John Ryan, I'll talk to Hilborn and see, but there's nothing in the works as of this moment, and there's a busy weekend, actually double weekend for wrestling stuff, so.
Yeah.
Maybe. I think the next call that'll probably come out on Heelborn is either the Gami Bitch call or Donkey Kong. One of the two. Actually, it'll probably be it might be neither. I have to get with Pat. So, Count of Three said, "Did I miss you? Comment on new RSO." He looks terrible.
He does look really bad. He looks really tired.
Yeah, he's got. It almost looks like black eyes.
Yeah.
But either, I think it's just dark circles.
Yeah, either he got, like, a GTS to the face, or he didn't sleep very well. I'm going to go with he probably didn't sleep very well, because he sleeps, like, an hour a night.
Yeah, well, absolutely. And definitely reboners rise up, or whatever. Hope y'all had fun. Again, next week, are you going to join me next week?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll be joining you next week.
We will be doing a call I found by accident.
It's good.
I was like, let's just try this day. And basically, how do I sum it up? I know, like, when the robot first came out, I saw people, big win for Hannah Head's World Order. for those that said in the beginning of the robot that, like, Lorne's charge wasn't brought up enough and yada yada, this call covers that and it's pretty fire.
People can't wait sometimes.
Well, that too, you know, they just assume they've heard three calls that thing doesn't happen all the time, but...
It's a good call, though.
It is a good call.
Let's bring in on more questions.
Yeah, I know. I guess I shouldn't have said anything at all. I'm sorry, guys. That's more questions from answering the question that everyone kept asking. So, it's good, though. Oh, Pee-wee, you're too kind, sir. Booba, you got anything else going on? I think you're busy this week, right?
I have a lot to do this week, but...
Sorry. George Glassner. Good one.
I think I'm on with Wes. I haven't talked to him in a while, but I will get with him and figure out if we're doing Mo Negro's Monday.
Okay. Caleb, to your question of why the sky blue, how's the rainbow made? It just does. Alright, I think that's about it. We got a banger closeout. Real short song for you guys. Should we just play the full song?
And just confuse everyone? I don't know if I want to sit through the whole song.
Alright, we'll just sing through the...
Actually, play the whole song. I'll sit through it, because I want to hear it.
Okay, we're gonna play the whole song. I probably won't even mute for it. We'll just laugh at it. I hope you had fun again. Thank you for spending your Sundays with us. See you on the next one. Thank you for all the donated paper thin walls. Goodbye.
Here's your new baby, and he is perfect as can be. Let's hope his life is not too rough. Why give his genitals cosmetic surgery? He seems quite well endowed, but what guy has enough? I wish my parents had defied conformity, preserved my pleasure part so I could feel it glide. That amputation won't prevent an STD, and infants aren't at risk. Why steal my right to decide? I don't want much, just want my foreskin back again. No, it's not TMI, I shared it cause we're friends. My parents chose this road, but I'll choose where it ends. Don't I deserve it all? Gonna grow it back again. Grow it back again.
Come on, guys, grow it back again. Let's do this.
You can do it if you
leave hard. I'm gonna fix me.
Yeah. Let's tug.
It's gonna take some time, but I can grow an inch a year.
Wow.
That's not so fast. New skin will last.
Seems like a lot.
So go ahead and laugh.
I'm scared.
At the tugger I strap on every night. To undo superstition, I tried to supersede my rights.
Dedicated.
Move it up, your sitcom victim won't remember a thing. Except to unite him, all the joy that love should bring. 2 million more mutilations every year.
You
have got to know it's wrong. Just let it die. Let the last victim try to grow it back again.
We know we're
alive. Yeah, we know we're alive.
Grow it back again, yeah. You talked Bill Gates out of a few Harvard simoleons to do a so-called study where you cut some Africans. Now it's still clear that condoms are the best form of prevention. Now that you failed, who will heal those angry men? I'm gonna tug and grow my foreskin back again. No, it's not TMI, I shared it cause we're friends. My parents chose this road, but I'll choose where it ends. Don't I deserve it all? Gonna grow it back again. Grow it back again. Grow it back again. Grow it back again.
She's got a big oily foreskin. All right, guys. See you next.